Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
It is Thursday, the sixth day of December 2012. And we have one of the audience's most popular guests, Gerald Celente, always informative, joins us at least once a month. He's joining us in the second hour today, and we'll also open the phones up. Matt Drudge, the giant of internet news, has come out and basically called out to the emperor and the fact that the emperor is wearing no clothes, or that there is a trillion-pound rabid elephant in the room, and that is the new lies that are even more asinine than claiming that Saddam Hussein had nuclear weapons and having some different fraudulent Iraqi defectors come and testify to the fact, because at least Saddam had some type of program in the past. And I'm, of course, was a big critic of that. Finally, somebody who's really big in the media is talking about something that we have been just screaming and yelling over, and McClatchy finally covered it. In fact, will you guys repull that and the article out of yesterday's stack where Al-Qaeda promises that after Assad falls to attack America with the missiles? This is all in the British and German and French news. With the missiles our government and NATO gave them. Now, that said, France is leading the warmongering drum to invade. And there's a U.S. Aircraft carrier and amphibious landing force right off the coast. This is incredible. And there's U.S. special forces, admittedly, for at least 9 months, the 22-month operation against Syria. They're backing up al-Qaeda. But what is Drudge doing? It's up at Infowars.com. He sends it out on his @Drudge Twitter. This is a big deal. Drudge chides Obama over hysterical Syria WMD rhetoric. And he just says, well, this is total hysteria to push an attack on Syria, and in a buildup to Rice, the U.S. ambassador of the U.N., going and pushing for this. And we told you, I don't know, 6 months ago, in fact, get Syrian girl on in the third hour if we can do it. I know she's in another time zone. It's the middle of the night. But will you get her? Yeah, that gives you an idea. She's not in the Middle East, folks. Will you get her on tomorrow if you can, or on the Sunday show for like 30 minutes? And then we have another guest on the Sunday show. Because everything she talked about a year ago is now coming true. But we've been covering the destabilization operation in Syria for 21 and a half months. I was rounding up when I said 22 months. And it doesn't matter. The al-Qaeda rebels put out videos showing their chemical weapons that they're going to use. And then they're going to blame it on the Syrian government. And that's going to be the invasion. But never before have they been caught with their pants down like this. Because the globalists think you're so stupid that they are going after the Assad regime, who's not perfect but wasn't attacking anybody, with real al-Qaeda. That's the main force. In fact, guys, will you print me the CFR thing from 3 months ago? Just type in CFR says we, quote, need al-Qaeda. That'll pull up the InfoWars article. You can print that. Then that will link to the CFR report. Print that. Now that I think about it, I want to just re-show all this stuff to people, along with the McClatchy. There's an LA Times. Well, there's hundreds of articles out there saying, well, there is al-Qaeda, part of the force. And, well, yeah, they're about half the force. Well, actually, they're leading the force. Well, actually, they are the force. And we could get our liberties back. This could kill the hoax of al-Qaeda, the hoax of 9-11, all of it. No matter what you think about 9-11 and who really did it, the point is it's been used to take our liberties. And the government is now running al-Qaeda. That is not in debate here. Okay? If you want to drive a stake through the myth of terrorism and that you need to give your rights up or you're dead, then this is the time, because it's cresting. Drudge is going to be able to probably push it over the edge. And that is a bold move, too, because let me tell you, that Drudge has the power to really get the wave going to kill this myth. And if this happens, just like the myth of global warming died at Copenhagen and the global carbon tax 3 years ago, this could be the destruction of the second Death Star that we're talking about here. We'll be right back. Stay with us. And you are right in the middle of it. You don't have front row seats, ladies and gentlemen. You are on the field in the battle to save our republic and planet Earth from the clutches of the New World Order corporate crime syndicate that's anti-free market, anti-freedom, who wants a worldwide scientific dictatorship over humanity to carry out the orderly extermination of over 80% of the planet's population so the, quote, elite can enjoy all the resources for themselves and enjoy the life extension technologies they believe will give them immortality. That is the reason they're in a death race to set up their world extermination grid, shut off the resources, soft kill the population with chemical and biological weapons in the food, water, and air. In fact, I was just reading last night, they just declassified more Department of Energy documents to even later, injecting people at public hospitals with uranium and plutonium and watching them die by the thousands. This has been ongoing, a spraying cities with radiation. And it's just a minor footnote on the news as I was driving along listening to Fox News Radio last night driving home. And it's so passe. I know this so well that I didn't even remember this morning to go print it off and cover it. Will you guys get me new nuclear testing on citizens released or declassified? And then 2 days ago, I was listening to a talk radio, and they were saying, can you believe, and reading an AP report, that Verizon has filed a patent where the television set in your smartphones, that they will dial into them when you don't know and have computers listen for keywords to sell you advertising. Well, that's just the cover. That's beyond 1984. I do believe it. 6 years ago, Paul Watson noticed the Google patent and their press release to shareholders in 2006, so almost 7 years ago. That's a prisonplanet.com article. In fact, I have them doing a flashback today. Steve Watson's doing another report on it, tying it in. Folks, this is system-wide. This is system-wide beyond 1984. Hundreds of patents. We've had Dr. Begich on to list the patents where they flicker the television to mesmerize you into a dream state. It just goes on and on and on. We are under unmitigated attack. You are living in a science fiction movie. But the globalists engineer this and roll it out in phases. And very few people are privy to the entire program. Even though most of it's public, even the technocrats themselves are so specialized generally and so lazy that after they do their special technical work, they go play golf or whatever. And so the very small technocratic elite that Brzezinski's written about, that globalists have bragged about, they're in control of all this. And so people say, well, why don't they kill you? Because they factored in the rise of individuals that would resist them. And they talk about it, and they use it as a wargaming tool to test and make themselves better against humanity. It's very, very sick. I know we can beat them. And then there's a lot of different ways to do it, but one big issue is they don't always get what they want. They're not all powerful. They're 6 to 7 to 8 to 9 to 10 years behind, depending on which one of their actuaries you look at where they admit all this. Brzezinski says about a decade behind. I think he's exaggerating a little bit. But when you look at all this, they, even though they make mistakes and screw up, they still just regroup and keep moving. A basic 160-year-old eugenics program developed by the British Empire. And the fact that the institutions have been built to carry this out is why they can't even deviate from the program, because once it starts, it's like a perpetual motion machine or a doomsday machine that once they've triggered it, because a lot of them now actually want to reverse it because they've figured out it's going to be really nasty and the machines are probably going to end up taking over. But they can't themselves even stop it. And it's in that thought that we may actually be able to beat this, because you can stop it. You can stop it. You are just beginning to understand that it may not be able to be stopped. And you, as control freaks, don't like that. What you just thought, you were going to conjure absolute scientific crystalline dehumanization and evil because you were going to control it as you evolve to the next level. If you were evolved to the next level, quote, as you call it, you would understand that whatever you do will come back on you and there is no way to escape it. The only escape, you're not going to con this evil system, or you're not going to escape it. The only way is to deny your Faustian bargain, even if it physically destroys you, to get your soul out of what you've done. And Faust could have gotten out of it anytime he wanted. Everyone should go read Goethe's Faust. Everyone should go read it. Because it's a parallel to everyone's own life, but especially a technocrat, elitist system and life. And the only way you're going to get out of this is admitting that what we've built and the feedback loop into the group collective, the group consciousness, is going to destroy everyone. You cannot conjure Black Death directly out of the dimension of Hades and escape it. You will not escape it. Okay, I just want to, again, communicate directly to the globalist here. You will not escape this. You will not control this. You will not get out of this unless you deny it and stand against it. Because I'll use the Forbidden Planet parallel. Great film from back in the 1950s, really the precursor to Star Wars, Star Trek, all of it, and with the late Leslie Nielsen, that was his name. One that loved the actor, but I know he just died last week or the week before last. And in that, they've sent an expedition to a planet. I'm using this as a parallel, an analogy. And there's these underground, you know, cities that are there, but no sign of the large humanoid advanced civilization that built this giant underground power source to where they could, with their minds, manifest reality. And the krill, they discover, didn't, you know, billions of years before, don't know why they destroyed themselves. You know, in the end, they can't turn it around. They can't stop it. And Dr. Morpheus, who's the only survivor when the rescue ship gets there decades later, a space marine craft gets there, and everyone was torn limb from limb by some invisible force, and all only people alive are Dr. Morpheus and his daughter, because the rest of the ship, you know, the rest of that group were blasting off to leave the planet. They didn't like what was going on there. And at the end, Morpheus finally discovers that it's his subconscious that is manifesting and working the controls that is creating, you know, this energy force that is tearing people limb to limb. And that is exactly what the corrupt globalists are doing. I mean, you will destroy yourselves. Your seed will not go forward. You will destroy yourself. And I know at the very top of the Illuminati, they know that, and they believe it's a sacrifice of the planet, and they're so committed to death and destruction that they just wish to sink to the, you know, lowest level of hell, you know, gravitationally into a black hole, into the core of the planet, if you want to use that analogy. It is their ether. It is what they long for. It is what they wish to be a part of. And so they are one with it. And so that is their nature. But then you've got the mid-level Luciferians, people you see on TV, the presidents, these, you know, worldly globalists. And with them, it's all about competition and being top dog, and they enjoy the narcissism of it. And, you know, there's a lot of occult stuff going on, and power and bizarreness and ritual and things that they're just basically into. And they really believe they're going to be given life extension technology. They really believe they're going to have all this power and transcend. They really buy it all. And so I'm here to give you the little newsflash. You are not going to get any of that. Okay? You understand that? You have been deceived. And you will be destroyed as a monument to Satan's beauty. Now, that's from the perspective of the dark force. You can call it whatever you want. But that's beauty to them. Okay? I'm just telling you. This planet destroyed, everything on it dead. That's the goal. That's the goal. But first, the creation must be dehumanized and deformed and diseased and poisoned, and as a great offering to darkness, all the pain resonance must be sucked off the globe first before wiping it out. Now that is what the Illuminati at the highest level seeks. Total death, total destruction, and that's what all of you have signed on to. And a lot of little globalist minions want to be nihilist. They kind of giggle and hop around when they hear that and go, that's right, that's right. You know, it's in the poetry of a lot of globalists. It was in Lenin's poetry. That's really what they're seeking. I mean, it's not a destination. It's the journey of death and destruction. And then at a very deep level, they just want it all to end. And so they see total destruction as their absolution. And that is the great dream of those we fight. So I thought I'd just tell you why things are getting so ugly, and this is just the beginning. You will look back on these days as the times of milk and honey. Now, when we come back, it's finally hitting the news that our government runs Al-Qaeda, and there's aircraft carrier massing, amphibious forces getting ready for the invasion of Syria. And, of course, they've got a giant Al-Qaeda force ready to land them to back them up, along with U.S., British, and other Arab country special forces. Qatar and others, just like they landed in Tripoli en masse to overthrow Gaddafi last year. We'll be right back. Let's get into some really positive news. You see, the globalists need to totally overturn reality. They need to have a government, a global government, that's been caught in Europe, Australia, the U.S., Russia, China, African countries, you name it. They all do it because they all get IMF and World Bank money to do it. Injecting people with cancer viruses, giving little kids polio, shooting people up with radioactive isotopes, killing them. It's always going on. I mean, they're always apologizing every week or two for something new. Oh, we're going to stop this time, but we're not going to talk about the scientists or why they were ordered to do it or why the government says it's legal under U.S. Code Title 50, Chapter 32, Subsection 1528, Paragraph B, where it says you can't do any human testing on people without their knowledge. Unless it's for law enforcement or research reasons. And it says you can use lethal stuff on people. Now, that's obviously unconstitutional. They had laws saying blacks weren't humans. They had laws saying women couldn't vote. I mean, you know, the point is, though, the scientists have demanded this, and they like testing on you. Now, see, why would you take vaccines run by big pharma, owned by big mega banks, who all have eugenics backgrounds, most of them right to the Nazis? I mean, you know about Bayer, you know about all these companies, Eli Lilly, you know about all these guys? It's time for you to learn. It's time for you to find out. It's time for you to understand what we're in and that 99.999% of us, it's only a few thousand globalists, are under attack. You think you're serving this system? It's incredible. Let's go back to these articles here. That said, our government, a foreign banker run, created Al-Qaeda, Zbigniew Brzezinski, 79, used him in the 80s against the Russians, used him in the 90s against the Serbs. When the Serbs fought back, NATO bombed the daylights out of them with DU weapons, blowing up TV stations, water treatment, power plants, you know, just absolutely knocked them back into the Stone Age. People say, don't you, the Serbs were bad too. Yeah, ethnic wars are bad. The point is the globalists sent Al-Qaeda into Albania, the KLA, it's on record. And they did it again and again and again and again. They use Al-Qaeda against America to then take our liberties as well. Now, over 10,000 missiles on record are missing, most of them heat-seeking. You aim it at an aircraft, it can go 5,000, some of them 10,000 feet in the air. Aircraft's taking off, flying in, you shoot them down. They're shipping them in to Syria in the last 20-plus months. They are using them there. The ones they captured in Libya, but they're also giving them U.S.-made. Those are surfacing. U.S.-made mortars are used to fire into Turkey, so Turkey can then use artillery to attack Syria to open up areas to insert more Al-Qaeda out of U.S. bases on the border. This is, by the way, in the news. Our military with Al-Qaeda, who are so proud of themselves, they're quoted in McClatchy News. Al-Qaeda-linked group Syrian rebels once denied, now key to anti-Assad victories, and they brag. They say, go read. They say, yes, we are Al-Qaeda. Yes, we killed your soldiers in Iraq, and when we're done, we will kill more Americans. And now we have missiles. There's several McClatchy articles on this in the LA Times. You know, 6-7 months ago admitted, okay, there is Al-Qaeda. The CFR says, you know, the Al-Qaeda specter, that's the headline. And then down deeper in it, right here in the document cam shot, I'll show people right over here. McClatchy exclusive, Syrian faction linked to Al-Qaeda. It's like saying Hitler was linked to the Nazis. Effective rebel group has ties to terror group. U.S. maintains. Oh, so it's maintaining. Oh, there's Al-Qaeda. Kind of like they used Al-Qaeda against Libya. Now they've got to go into Libya again and stay there to take out Al-Qaeda. And then the very Al-Qaeda group they use goes and kills the ambassador because he just transferred in a deal with Turkey. That was a weapons cache. We said that day one. Now it's been confirmed to Turkey to be given to the Al-Qaeda. And more, I don't even think that guy had cold feet or was a whistleblower. What's emerged is they just wanted to get rid of the witness. So when they use these missiles to shoot down U.S. and European airliners and use it to set up checkpoints 5 miles from the airport, because that's how they're going to roll TSA out. They're already all set and ready in every city and town. They're going to just say, oh, Al-Qaeda blew up, 10 airliners today. America is now under civil emergency. And I'll be probably taken off the radio, knowing them, because they don't want anybody coming on and going, do you remember AP, Reuters, McClatchy, back of the paper, LA Times? But they're always like, yeah, they're effective. You know, what's the CFR say? Here's the article right here. Al-Qaeda specter in Syria. And it goes on to say the Syrian rebels would be immeasurably weaker today without Al-Qaeda in their ranks. And they go on to say, quote, we need Al-Qaeda. Thank goodness, goody, goody gumdrop. And they quote Reuters, we need Al-Qaeda. Because Assad's so bad. Yeah, Assad doing nothing to anybody. But it's Iran's ally, so it's got to be taken down. And they're using five groups, four of them Al-Qaeda, to attack Iran while Hillary gets on the news and says, we have to attack Iran. They're Al-Qaeda. Now, here's the big news when we come back, because it is big news. Drudge chides Obama over hysterical Syria WMD rhetoric. That's right. We've got to go into Syria because, get this, Al-Qaeda is in Syria. That's right. We have to, and they have chemical weapons. We'll be back. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Let me get into this Syria situation news, because next stop is Iran. General Wesley Clark talked about being at the Pentagon in meetings. He talked about it, 6 years ago on C-SPAN, that a few years before that, he was there at the Pentagon. And they said, here are the eight nations we're going to attack. Here is the order, and it's the exact order. And he was talking about weeks before they went to war with Iraq. Actually, he was talking about late 2001, so I guess it was 11 years ago, and then he talked about it 6 years ago, because it was right after 9/11, and he's at the Pentagon, and they're saying, no, we're going to attack Iraq, we're going to then attack this country, we're just going to get this war launched in the name of 9/11. In fact, guys, since I mentioned it, will you guys pull up the Wesley Clark list of nations to be attacked clip and find the highest res one? That'll probably be the one with the most views. Because I don't want to talk about something like that and then not play it for new listeners. We've probably played it 30 times over the years, but I want to play it again later because it's so important. And again, we're sold. Hey, it's for America. We're going to wipe out, the Muslim extremist, the globalist. If you are an Islamophobe out there and really get into that and the media hypes it, well, why are our governments then bringing in record numbers of Muslims into Europe and the United States and Australia and everywhere else? I mean, if they're just such incredible terrorists, they just want a clash of civilizations. It's more divide and conquer. That's what's going on. And they don't want secular advanced civilization in the Middle East, because a lot of civilization began there. The alphabet, mathematics, they're really smart people. But they take the Bedouins that are kind of like, the hillbillies or whatever, not knocking hillbillies either, of the middle of what is Saudi Arabia, give them the entire region, call it Saudi Arabia when it wasn't even a country. This is the British again, about 100 years ago. You can look it up. Lawrence of Arabia, the film, is based on that, but it's a whitewash. And they put them in charge. And then they've exported those guys and their ideas to all the countries and even into Central Asia, which isn't even the same culture or group. And they have just put them everywhere, and they are the bosses. And it's the great divide and conquer. And they've taken down Libya that was building up all of Africa. And I'm no fan of goofy dictators and, jumpsuits and fancy sunglasses. But the point is, he was building up all of Africa. Because you can have a philosopher king who actually doesn't give the money to the bureaucracy that actually builds giant airports and buildings and aquifers. And you could call it narcissism, but maybe he was trying to be a good guy. Muammar Gaddafi, he built up all of Africa, and the globalists were hopping mad. He was trying to get them on a gold standard. He wanted their own African Union that wasn't globalist controlled. And then 7 years ago, 8 years ago, they came to Gaddafi, and they said, this is all on record, invest your oil money in Goldman Sachs, JP Morgan, Bank of England, the big French banks, German banks, and we'll leave you alone. He said, hey, Westerners, come on in. And he brought in all the big companies. He said, I want to work with you. He apologized for funding terrorism, as they called it, for the last 40 years. That's how long that guy was there. and they totally stole the country's money. He started complaining about it. And remember, he was saying Obama was great and his friend, and he wanted to go visit Obama. Remember all that? And how he wanted to be friends with America. This was before, this was when Bush was in, he was saying all this. And they totally set him up, stole the country's money, and then went in and blew the infrastructure to pieces. And they did it starting, it took them about 9 months again to take over. They brought in massive al-Qaeda jihadis into Benghazi, out of Egypt, out of Saudi Arabia, to the east. They gave them missiles, anti-aircraft, you name it. And our media called them peaceful protesters while they were burning buildings, blowing up police stations, rocket attacks. They had tanks. They even had aircraft in some cases. And for 6 months of it, they wouldn't even call it a war. They would like peaceful people tried to protest. And the Gaddafi had rape gangs raping them fueled by Viagra. Just like they lied and said Saddam was throwing babies out of incubators. Later admitted, total lie, no truth. PR firm put it out. Yeah, but people buy it. And, it's how the demonization works. Now, it'd be one thing if Gaddafi did some more terror or something and they assassinated him. I mean, that would be bad enough because it's very bad to start killing heads of state in destabilization programs because that's global empire. And again, we're not America anymore. We've been taken over too. Remember that. But they put al-Qaeda into Benghazi and it took them 9 months to take over. And finally, they landed U.S., British, and Qatar and a bunch of other Arab special forces, thousands of them, in a night amphibious bold landing in Tripoli. And of course you'll never see movies about that because it's al-Qaeda and our special forces. I don't know how the Navy SEALs, I don't know how the CIA commandos, because there's levels above Navy SEALs and Delta Force. I don't know how they go do something that immoral. And you've noticed they fired six or seven generals who were speaking out. They've been purging people. They've been purging special forces. It is so immoral. I mean, our government's been corrupt for a while, folks, but this is arrogant to the max because everyone that's educated knows this is going on. The whole world knows this. You know, al-Qaeda hit us on 9/11, we're told, but our government runs al-Qaeda. And they ran them then. It was in Newsweek at the time. It was everywhere that the hijackers were trained at U.S. bases, that the hijackers were given national security clearances, that the head of the U.S. embassy in Saudi Arabia wouldn't let them in saying they're terrorists and was told by the CIA, here's a State Department order, these are our guys, the terror designation is a cover. And then the head of the Defense Language School, Colonel Butler, in the San Jose Mercury News came out and said, I don't know what's going on, but the government's behind this because ADA and other hijackers trained, those guys in the photos trained at our base and had national security clearances. And then they started a court-martial of him for releasing national security info. He agreed to not talk about it and they dropped it. I mean, this is in the news. If news people are listening, I know Congress people are listening. I get congressmen on all the time, never had on before, and they go, whenever I'm in my district or whatever, in fact, I heard you yesterday talking about this or that. I mean, they really listen. I mean, that's all there. I mean, I people are like, but I thought al-Qaeda's bad, Alex. Of course they're bad. The foreign banks use them to attack us so that government can take our rights. I mean, is that not hard to figure out? You can still have your hatred of the Muslims and be scared of them and everything, okay? I'm not taking that away. I know that's what is near and dear to people. I'm just explaining the globalists are using that to take our liberties. Okay, and because I know it's fun to be tribal. I know the government, won't let you be tribal about anything and tells you you can't even have the American flag on your shirt or you're racist and all that. But in that one area, you're allowed to be tribal and hate the Muslims. Okay, I get it. The Muslims are very diverse. Most of the Muslims want freedom. What you've been told about them is a divide and conquer lie. And our criminal foreign banker-controlled government and the European Union and all of them, it's all banker-run. It's the exact same policy worldwide. Is doing everything they can on so many fronts to overthrow good governments or governments that aren't radical and to put in the very worst. And it's all on record, ladies and gentlemen. And they think you're so ignorant. They think you're so brainwashed by the old narrative that al-Qaeda is hiding under every bed, every chair, every closet, and that the TSA has got to do this and that, and we've got to check your bank account, and you've got to have the NSA spy on you, and then you get all the training manuals. There's nothing about Al-Qaeda. It's all about returning veterans, gun owners, conservatives, libertarians, rural groups, marijuana growers. It's all about people that are off the plantation. Because there is a slave revolt worldwide against the technocracy, the New World Order. And here I am, man. I am the slave revolt leader in my sector. Okay? And the globalists are trying to con you into a fake revolt of communism and collectivism that is a jail cell. And I'm risking my life to do this. That's why they're assassinating my character in national media, but they know that has no credibility to people, so they are doing it through different operations at the grassroots that are actually snowball effects where operatives start the disinfo. That's been proven before with Hal Turner and others that were FBI attacking me every day. The same handbook others use. And then once the ball starts rolling, it's bigger and bigger as others pick it up. And the globalists are very intelligent. They have it all actuaried out. They can monitor with their Google Analytics across all platforms exactly what's happening. They know their attacks of me has the effect of making Alex Jones myself bigger, because they understand all publicity is good publicity. But it does hurt the movement for liberty when Alex Jones is being attacked. You see, it makes me bigger. Individually, more traffic, more listeners, who is this guy? But then they spin that energy field, that energy gravity buildup, they spin it and make it something negative. So I get to be the king in certain sectors of something very negative. So the attackers and the swarms they try to create, you know, the chain reactions they try to create, that actually makes Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com bigger. But it, like a prism, deflects and deforms the message that I'm sending out, and they try to spin it like judo into something that becomes an infighting mode within the entire Liberty Awakening movement as a distortion amplifier to basically then spin off other fights and to create that negative wavelength. You understand? And so, anyways, getting back to what I was saying, our government is not our government. And they are operating uncloaked, using Al-Qaeda against Libya, Syria, and Iran. And then they're already setting the narrative, because the Al-Qaeda group said on BBC with signs in English, they said, next stop Syria, when they killed Gaddafi a year ago. Remember that? They were already in Syria starting it then. They already started, you know, 10 months before that. 10 months before a year ago. And now they're saying, and it's in McClatchy, it's in the back of the news, like, but see, they're already spinning it, getting you ready. Oh, gee, there was some Al-Qaeda there. Looks like they got some missiles. Oh, we better really get into Syria quick, because Al-Qaeda might take over instead of the good people. Oh, gee, we don't know why Al-Qaeda got all these missiles. Oh, gee, we're going to, they started putting out 3 days ago that Obama's saying there might be some missing nukes now. Oh, America might get nuked. Oh, can you imagine what Obama will do if we get nuked? His approval rating will go to about 90%. Because people, out of fear, they won't really believe it when they get the call, but when the nuke goes off and the president's in there, I'm going to find who did it, Iran did it, and starts nuking Iran, people just be, I just better get behind the president. It's a primitive thing. And it'll be, and there's people showing dissent after, you know, after our city, after Dallas or Chicago or New York or L.A., whichever city they hit. After it got hit by the low yield, you know, 2 megaton, we've got 100,000 dead, 200,000 radiated. America will stand up and get together after this. And how dare you say your government did it, Jones? Arrest him. And they will arrest me. And then, well, I can just see when they walk me into that cell and those guys walk in, they're gonna torture me something good. And 5 years later, roll me out, electroshock, brain damaged. God only knows. And I'm ready. I'm ready, whatever it takes. I'm going all the way. I commit myself into the hands of God, because you are murderers injecting children with cancer viruses right now, and you run Al-Qaeda, and you are the scum of the earth, and I stand against you. I'm not worried about it. I'm in God's hands. You better worry about God. And I know you low-level folks don't know there's a God, but your gut knows there's a God. And you will pay for your evil. You will pay for Abu Ghraib and raping those children and killing them in front of their parents. And you will, all of you will pay. 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 You will pay in this life, and you will pay in Hades. All right, continuing here. Here is DrudgeReport.com, and he put it out on his Twitter, at Drudge. And here is the headline. Drudge chides Obama over hysterical Syria WMD rhetoric. Matt Drudge chided President Obama over his increasingly hysterical rhetoric regarding the supposed WMD threat posed by Syria in a tweet that harken back to Colin Powell's infamous UN appearance, which relied on fabricated evidence to justify the invasion of Iraq. Continuing, here is the tweet. Obama playing up WMD threat. Can we retweet that? I meant to do that this morning. I never did. Obama playing up WMD threat in Syria is bold and hysterical. Who will go to UN to show evidence this time? Maybe one of the Rices. Yeah, like they sent Colin Powell. I mean, this is bold of Drudge, because obviously this is also going to go back to WMDs and Bush and Colin Powell. Obama playing up WMD threat in Syria is bold and hysterical, and it's bold of Drudge to expose it. Who will go to the UN to show evidence this time? Maybe one of the Rices, tweeted the editor of DrudgeReport.com in the aftermath of the Obama administration's increasing hype over a chemical weapons threat based on little else but hearsay and conjecture. Drudge's reference to the UN is, of course, a reminder that contrived threats about Saddam Hussein's non-existent weapons of mass destruction were used to grease the skids for an attack on Iraq that cost over $1 trillion and well over 4,000 dead U.S. troops over the last 9.5 years. Yeah, and they have got different estimates from 800,000 to 1.5 million Iraqis dying one way or another from the war. That's Lancet, British Medical Journal. In February 2003, Colin Powell went before the UN Security Council and claimed that Iraq was hiding weapons of mass destruction and refused to disarm. He dramatically held up a vial of white powder, remarking that the same amount had shut down the U.S. Senate in 2001, implying they did it, which, of course, was U.S. weapons grade out of U.S. labs. That's all now been on record, aim strain out of Fort Detrick. Most of the claims Powell made during the speech, including the infamous Niger yellowcake issue, were fabricated and based on testimony of an intelligence asset named Rafid Ahmed Alwan al-Jabai, or Curveball, an Iraqi defector who later admitted that it had been completely manufactured lies about Saddam having mobile bioweapons trucks and clandestine factories. Powell later admitted that he had misled before the UN speech and said that he regretted the incident. Syrian President Bashar al-Assad has repeatedly asserted that Syria will not use its chemical weapons arsenal to target rebel fighters, never mind the civilian population. To do so would be an act of geopolitical suicide, given that Obama and Hillary Clinton have made it clear that this is the red line that will mandate U.S. military intervention. The sudden deluge of hysteria suggesting the Syrian military is preparing to use chemical weapons against its own people and is awaiting final orders from President Bashar al-Assad is based entirely on dubious claims by anonymous U.S. officials. And they've got the rebel group videos with them with chemical weapons to run the false flag. And they've got the U.S. aircraft carrier with the three amphibious Coronada-type ships ready to land and disgorge the al-Qaeda jihadis. By the way, that's Steve Voss. We've had him on the show. Last time I checked, we sell his CDs. Amazing country singer. Can we get, because I know the network has it, but can we get, in fact, let's buy it online, because he's told me I can play the stuff on air. But I want to get the latest, highest res of that. The CDs are around here, too. I want to play the Renegades and maybe put more of his music in rotation. Years ago it was. I don't know why. Most of it's fallen out. Love his song, Talk Radio. All of it. Speaking of books and videos, we have None Dare Call a Conspiracy by Gary Allen and Larry Abraham available at InfoWarsStore.com. We have Nullification, 10th Amendment, Rightful Remedy, States' Rights. We talk about secession from the New World Order. That's at InfoWarsStore.com. You can get a year subscription for yourself and then pass it on to others, or give gift subscriptions. And the shipping is included in the low price at InfoWarsStore.com to InfoWars Magazine, the latest issue. This Man Wants Your Guns, 60 pages, color glossy, and you support the First Amendment and print 2.0. Very effective. It also has the complete Ron Paul farewell address. Get your gift subscription for Christmas for folks. And also, until the 10th, we are offering, that's just four more days, you can get the Pro Pure Water Filtration Gravity-Fed Stainless Steel System. Blows the competition away. We have side-by-side comparison scientific studies right at InfoWarsStore.com. University studies and links right there where it blows away the competition. Costs less money, 15% off with promo code WATER15. We already had the lowest price, 15% off that at, with the promo code WATER15 at InfoWarsStore.com or call 888-253-3139. And also, you get 10 memberships for the price of one at prisonplanet.tv. And it's a great way to see the radio show video, the nightly news, all my films, so much more. 17 years of material, almost 10 years up and operating with prisonplanet.tv. Takes about a minute to sign up, 15 cents a day, normally for one person a month. Well, now you can get it, and 10 people. Well, it's the user and 10 more, so 11 people technically, they corrected me yesterday, can log in with the same username and passcode. So create a unique username passcode, give it an e-card to people and say, here is your InfoWarsNews.com membership. Boom! And they're at InfoWars News, InfoWarsNews.com. Okay, I want to... That door is open, guys. If you guys could just shut that for me, thanks a million. Okay, continuing here, studio door pops open. Drudge chides Obama over hysterical Syria WMD rhetoric. And again, I know this is painful stuff to hear, but I mean, it's in McClatchy News, it's in the CFR, it's in the back of the LA Times, and then they're already starting the new spin of, looks like Al-Qaeda's going to hit us with missiles that they got in Libya. Oh my gosh, we better get... And I've seen the headlines that Al-Qaeda is in Iran. We've got to attack them. Iran is Shiite. The Shiites and Sunnis hate each other on average 100 times worse than you think there's a Christian or even Jewish clash, because they live by each other and they've been killing each other for 700 years. And a lot of them live in peace, too, but, I mean, that's where the real lines are. And the Shiites have had to be pretty darn rough to not be overtaken by the 80% majority Sunni. And there's the poor Alawites and stuff that are less than 1%, they just mow them down. Al-Qaeda is in Syria, killing Christians, killing Alawite Muslims, burning down, making people suicide bomb or they kill their families. And our media has run with it like it's a good thing. I mean, it's so immoral. Hey, torture's good. Hey, running Al-Qaeda's good. By the way, we got to spy on all American citizens because of Al-Qaeda. And you're like, what? But you're Al-Qaeda. So good job, Drudge, pointing this out. And hour number two, Gerald Celente is joining us in the third hour today. I thought it was in the second hour. That's what my sheet said, but it's actually in the third hour. Old time zone issue there. So that'll always be informative. We're going to cover a host of issues. In fact, he said, what are the talking points? And by talking points, what do you want to get into? What are the subjects? And I just said, hey, whatever you want to cover. And, of course, I've got some of my points and questions. I want to play Howard Dean saying, hey, not just the rich need to pay taxes. Everybody needs to pay more. Well, don't worry. You will. 3.8% basically on all investments on top of the other taxes. We're talking $6,000-$8,000 a year, one way or another, making you buy health care. That'll drive up the price. It's already happened. They're getting rid of basically all the deductions, and it's just going to get worse and worse. And they're going to control the health care. So that's going on. I want to give the toll-free number out to join us on air when we come back from the break. And I really think I'm up to it, actually going to your calls and getting to a lot of them. So start your engines. Be ready when we come back in the next segment. First-time callers on all the things we've been talking about the last few weeks or any points that you want to raise. I'm going to give the number out when we come back, and then we will give everybody a chance to be on air because I really want to hear from you. And I love the wild card aspect of just going to your phone calls. If you just joined us, I was covering Al-Qaeda link group, Syrian rebels once denied now key to anti-Assad victories, and Drudge has come out and said, what are you going to go to the UN and make up that they're going to use WMDs? I mean, it would be suicide for Assad to do that. Saddam had some chemical weapons that the UN hadn't found. He didn't use them. Our government blew a bunch of them up in the first Gulf War, and our troops all briefed it. And the government said, oh, those are false alarms, those thousands of alarms they had that went off. It was chemical tape, folks, that has stripes when it comes into sarin or VX. They said, oh, never mind all that, and don't worry, you're going to die about 50 years young, but and get ready to go home and die. We care about you, though. Hey, salute those troops. Don't bring anything up negative. You know, a lot of times veterans are the core of our audience, great supporters, smart people who aren't naive. That's why Homeland Security demonizes them. But a lot of times it will be, though, the few people that will get in my face will be a guy, you know, with like the veteran vest on and the George W. Bush stuff on, and they'll walk over and go, I don't appreciate you running America down. I don't appreciate you putting down our troops. And I go, how am I doing that? Well, your lies about the Iraq war and all this stuff, and or you know, stuff like that. And they'll say, you know what I'm talking about. And I'm like, so putting the troops in a war that's a fraud and having them breathe nerve gas in the first Gulf War. Oh, but just, I don't want to hear from you. They're always, I don't want to. Probably happened 20 times over the years. I don't want to. I think I caught some of it on tape at the Grand Canyon. Nobody's at the giant visitor center. It looks like an aircraft carrier. And I'd been there, you know, in 97 to make America Troy by Design. It was a small business visitor center. Now it was a huge one. We've seen the video on YouTube. I uploaded it literally minutes later in my car. And I walk over. Nobody's around. Literally nobody's around. And there's the UN sign saying that, you know, it's UN-controlled World Heritage Site and the treaty and the UNESCO and what it all means. The same sign I videotaped in America Troy by Design. So I wanted to shoot some video of that. And the guy hears me talking. He comes walking by with his wife. They're about 10 feet behind me because I hear him. He goes, hold on, honey. And I'm sitting there talking while this is happening, but I can do two things at once. I hear him go, hold on, honey. I want to see what this guy's saying. And he's got like his, you know, his army hat on, or I think it was Navy, and he's got all this American flags all over in a vest, and he walks over. He goes, this guy won't get out of my way. You know, he heard me saying, the United Nations, you know, says they control this. Well, see, guys like that, they don't like hearing somebody runs America. I'm a traitor for saying that. Not that we should get America back. No, I'm the traitor for lying about America and saying America isn't strong. And he's like, what are you doing? I want to see what this is. This guy won't get out of my way. And I turn and I go, oh, really, buddy? I won't get out of your way. And he goes, and then he starts running off. Because I'm supposed to just go, oh, yes, sir. Oh, don't. Oh, my gosh, you're so tough. Don't hurt me. You know, it's disgusting. It's disgusting. Look, the globalists captured America. America's dead unless we admit it and take America back. That's not unpatriotic. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us for another hour of InfoWars. I'm Alex Jones, your host. It is Thursday, the 6th day of December, 2012, and we've already done 1 hour of transmission. Two more hours coming up. I may even go into overdrive again. Then I'll be back tonight with InfoWars Nightly News and the rest of my great crew. The news websites are PrisonPlanet.com and InfoWars.com. We stream video at InfoWarsNews.com. Okay, I want to just give the number out now for first-time callers and just take a bunch of calls and then get back into news because I've covered a bunch of news now in the first hour. The toll-free number to join us is 800-259-9231. For first-time callers today, 800-259-9231. Here it is. CFR strategist praises Al-Qaeda bombings in Syria. Unbelievable new article. McClatchy, exclusive Syrian faction linked to Al-Qaeda. Effective rebel group has ties to terror group. Like I said, like Hitler had ties to the Nazis. Council on Foreign Relations says they need Al-Qaeda. It goes on and on and on. And the Drudge Report, Matt Drudge comes out and tweets at Drudge and says, hey, you're hyping WMDs now, saying we need to invade Syria after 21 and a half months of backing Al-Qaeda. Drudge, I'm adding that. That's in the news. Drudge made the point of, let me just read what he actually said. Obama playing up WMD threat in Syria is bold and hysterical. Who will go to the UN to show evidence this time? Maybe one of the ISIS. And never has it been more clear that the globalists run Al-Qaeda. It's like a magic skeleton key. What's a skeleton key? It'll open any door, basically. Magic tool. And you need to take liberty from a country? Just stage an attack, blame an Al-Qaeda, or let Al-Qaeda attack. Need to take over a nation? Need to destabilize? Just say Al-Qaeda's there. It's amazing. Want to take down Libya? Send in Al-Qaeda. Then you want to invade Libya again? Say Al-Qaeda's there. Who you put there? But the media won't point that out. Or if they do, the public's so brain dead, who cares? Now they're in Syria. And then also coming up, Senator Inhofe, there's a video message for UN climate conference Obama quietly handing over billions of dollars to the UN in the name of global warming. Again, it's global taxes already begun. Congress wouldn't pass it. He's just doing it. Congress won't pass shutting down power plants. He's just doing it. Congress won't pass gun bans. He's saying he's just going to do it. Congress won't pass a Cybersecurity Act, as CBS News even admits, is Russian-style net censorship. He just signs an order, tells Congress they can't even see it. He'll order the bureaucracy what to do. Unprecedented. That's from Senate.gov. UN being given money outside of Congress. And what does Obama want with the fiscal cliff? He's saying, I won't take the Republican deal of $990 billion in new taxes. I won't take the new, on top of getting rid of basically all deductions, hundreds of billions a year. I read the Washington Post 2 days ago where they had the Republican breakdown. And even they were playing the game. Well, this is very reasonable. If Democrats were trying this, conservatives would be having convulsions on the ground. And Obama's like, nope, I will be given control of the automatic debt increase. You will vote to give it to me. A 50-50 vote will do it, if they get a simple majority. And he says, but then it'll take two-thirds to ever override me, which is basically almost impossible to get a two-thirds override on spending. I can't remember the last time that happened, a long time ago. Just like healthcare takes that big override. They want these chains on us. So it's 90% there, a dictator, when it comes to finances. But he doesn't care. They won't even pass it. He'll just do it. Signing statements. It goes on and on. Executive orders. We're in trouble. It's not a game to get up here and talk about the traitorous activities of the globalists through their puppet Obama. It's not fun to be on their enemies list. That came out 3 years ago. I'm on Obama's enemies list. Look it up. It's not fun, the stuff they do. It's not... That's why I get so angry at peacocks and people in the media who claim they're conservative that won't go after this stuff and that play softball because they're afraid and want their job. Folks, this is real evil. We've got to defeat this. And people are like, well, Romney was bad too. I know. They ran a political corpse, just like Bob Dole against Clinton in 96, to do that. It's rigged. Folks, you know I call elections like I see them from the real experts of my own, and I'm an expert on vote fraud, and I've been studying it for 17 years. Obama lost the election. They cheated him in all those states on records. Do you think Californians didn't want GMO labeling on food? Do you really believe polls showed 2-1 they were for labeling, but magically then they lost? Do you believe any of that? If the government will shoot foster kids up with uranium and give little kids last year under U.S. government-funded Bill and Melinda Gates live polio, and paralyze them. That was in the news, not even a big, bunch of kids, 60-something thousand are paralyzed after the polio vaccine, no big deal, nothing to see here. It's so over the top. Okay, yes, they'll engage in election fraud. I'm going to try to explain this. The robber barons in England and the U.S. and the European robber barons of 100 years ago, excuse me, funded the Kaiser Wilhelm Institute on record. And if you don't know what that is, this has even been in the London Guardian and New York Times. I say they lie. Sometimes they even tell the truth because they just think it doesn't even matter that our government and the British government, not just the robber barons, funded Lenin to take over. That's mainline history. Our government put Mao in 49. That's now declassified. Our government helped put Hitler in. And why did they do that? Why are they putting Al-Qaeda in Libya and Syria? Why are they putting Al-Qaeda Light, the Muslim Brotherhood, that's backing the folks in Gaza, no matter which side of that you're on? Because they're going to put the crazies in charge everywhere, and then they're going to kill them. And then they're going to let the crazies attack us so the government can play the part of drama queens taking your rights. They're trying to sell torture. They're trying to tell you you can't videotape cops. They're setting up checkpoints, the name of DWI, just to get you used to it all over the country, totally illegal. North Korea. This is a real takeover. And they need to get the cops and the firefighters and the police and the minions and the feds and the bureaucrats. And then I'm going to go to your calls, but Just look at how since 9/11, 11 years ago, the biggest group of yearly scholarships now, The biggest group of scholarships isn't in science, isn't in technology, isn't in literature, isn't in media, isn't in government, isn't in finance, isn't in business, isn't in sports medicine. It's in homeland security related things. And I've run into countless people. I've read the news articles, but I've run into them. They're like, you're right, Alex. I remember like 7, 8 years ago, I'd be at different events and things and different conferences and things I've gone to. And there'll be a guy going, yeah, I'm getting out of UT next year, or I'm getting out of A&M. It's all true. We go to the Threat Fusion Center. We can dial in and read everybody's mail, and we data mine. But, you know, computers look at it, and they tell us if there's a problem. And so that's the probable cause, because the computer said it saw a problem. It's not a human looking at it. The computer looked at it, so it wasn't a human looking at first. So it's okay for us to then look once it flags something. And you can just set the computer however you want. You know, they can say a peanut butter sandwich is Al-Qaeda and look at everything you're doing. And again, I already know all this, but I'm running into these people going, you have no idea, Alex, how bad it is. But I get to see it all. And I'm like, you little idiots. So it's not going to matter, because you're going to have millions of people with these degrees over the last 11 years, and this is their future, and they're going to do it, and they're going to run our lives, and they love it, and they're on power trips, and that's the end of it. Do you understand how much trouble we're in? I mean, TSA, you try to film, they run up like drama queens and say it's illegal when they know it's not. You're out on the road, cop will pull over and say, don't film us. What are you, a terrorist? You know, it's ridiculous. It's this make-believe, well, the government is Al-Qaeda. All of you that attack me, I deserve an apology, because now they publicly ran them against the Serbs. They publicly ran them against us on 9/11. They're publicly running them in the Middle East. And it is unbelievable. Folks, they got over 10,000 missiles. I told you that before it was even in the news. Heat seekers, some are radar guided. They say they're going to attack America with them. They've given Al-Qaeda missiles. Now they're going to set up highway checkpoints to search all the trucks. That's going to be the next phase. And I'll be on the air going, remember, remember, they gave them the missiles. I'm so sick of it. And now they're saying there's missing nukes. Get ready for a U.S. city to get hit. Oh, boy, when they start selling that narrative, look out. And they're going to grandstand when they kill 100,000 people. And I'll have to sit there on the news and watch them, the killers who blow up the city or let Al-Qaeda do it. And, and when World War III starts, folks, they're going to shut the media down. The kill switch is going in. And they've already are beta testing with cops, arresting bloggers and people. Two more cases today that criticize Obama. They get SWAT teamed for no reason. I mean, it's bad. And they're going to start a civil war in this country, and they're going to fill the re-education camps with us. And God, to people that work for the government, do you really have to do this to us? Do you really have to play along with all this? I mean, do you really want to dominate the American people this bad that you're going to start a civil war? Because believe me, it's not going to be pretty. We're going to go to break. I promise, come back to your calls. Robert. And then we're going to go to Jeff and Marcus and Jared and Brett and many others that are holding 800-259-9231. When you hear somebody hang up, that's your chance to call in. I'll just try to shut up, make your point, and I'll go to the next person. Let's see if we can take 20 calls until Celente joins us. Then I'll clear the phones. You can hold over if you want to talk to Celente, because I do want to get to quite a few calls today with Celente. It's just I'm risking my life to do this because I've got to. I can't just ignore what I know. And I got to be honest with you. I knew about the globalists, the New World Order, collectivism, and how bad it was when I got involved 17 years ago. I really got involved 19 years ago, but got on air 17. But I just, if I would have known what I knew then, what would I have done differently? Because this is so real. It's so over the top. And it's going to get crazier and crazier and crazier. And it's going to be horrible. We've got to stop it. We cannot go the way of the Soviet Union and Nazi Germany and Communist China. The globalists put all those people in. Let's not do it, folks. Let's not do it. Alex Jones here, back live. Let's talk to Robert in Florida. Robert, you're on the air. Welcome.
Hello, Mr. Alex. I tell you what an honor and privilege it is to talk to you. I've been a long-time info warrior, a long-time follower. I buy your products. I support your site, and I try to spread the word the best I can for those that will listen.
God bless you. Thank you, sir. Go ahead.
I appreciate everything you do, and I hope you're, I mean, I hope you do okay, but I have a couple questions. I drive a truck. I don't go cross-country. I'm basically, I just do within Florida, and I go to, you know, a little part of Georgia and back. I haven't seen any checkpoints yet. I haven't seen or heard anything. And people I've talked to, they haven't seen anything either. And I'm wondering, you know, if the day comes I ever run into one, you know, like you've always said, they're not officers. I mean, I'm downright going to say, look, you're not touching me. You're not going to search nothing. I mean, how would you handle a situation like that?
Well, let me explain what's happening. The feds have tried since Clinton to pay states, counties, and cities to do checkpoints. A Clinton grant, they shut down 290, I-35, and they would shut them down and have traffic backed up one time all the way to Round Rock. It was like 20-something miles. It was incredible. I have video of it in Police State 2000. So anybody that wants to see it, just type that into a search engine. It's online. And the cops didn't like doing it. They were just like waving cars through and going, you know, we've been, you know, we're told to do this. They know it's illegal and they know it's garbage. They know that you can see the drunk drivers at night, somebody swerving, driving erratically. You pull them over, it's probable cause. Now it's reckless driving. It's in the state code. Take them to jail. But setting up checkpoints, you know, to check license and driver's license, they let the illegals go because the judges tell them to. It's all a fraud. And with TSA, what they're doing is they're having, quote, they're calling them inspectors, like the feds are inspecting the police, inspecting the fire departments, inspecting the railways, and anything that takes federal money. So they're on highways that are federally funded or partially funded. They're in bus stations. They're in all 50 states now. And I understand, you run, you're saying, mainly just a few routes in Florida into Georgia and that whole corridor out to that mega peninsula. That's actually an area where I've seen TSA checkpoints in the news. The biggest area is Tennessee and the states bordering it. Louisiana, Mississippi, Arkansas, that whole area, you just type it in. I mean, it's all over the news. But they're also in Texas. They're in California. They're all over the place. I'm giving you a long answer. What you do is, if you're a commercial driver, you've opted in to say you're commercial, so you waive some of your rights, and that's how they say that they can search you. And then they use the trucks, that being done too, to now they're doing it to citizens. They'll even get the U.S. Army out at some of these checkpoints in California and Tennessee that we've gotten on video and been on the news to just really freak everybody out. But if you get called into one of those way stations and it's the TSA, you have to go to your congressperson over the issue and the county and others, because the police should not be there, the state police, whoever, with the TSA. But again, the feds just say, do this or no money. It's totally illegal to have the feds out of their jurisdiction. They're doing it. It's a power grab. And there is quiet pushback. That's why it's, but all 50 states have had deployed the kits for them to be on every road, everywhere. But it's not just TSA that's gone from, well, there's been an 11-fold increase in their numbers since 2001. You can pull that up. They now are magic wand bureaucrats, where they, a judge rules, a federal judge, in whichever circuit it is, covers New Mexico, remember last year, that public schools must be TSA trained because parents are suing over their daughters being groped, because that's now proliferating, the TSA style checkpoint. And so the TSA must go to the school and train their teachers on the procedure. And so when the TSA gives you a certificate, well, you're now able to stick your hands down the 12-year-old girl's pants because you're a pervert teacher. Or the TSA comes and advises, you can now have cameras in the bathroom. So they're going to be the people that just, I mean, I was out, you know, to speak in, it was a great event too. They had to get, add an extra night because it was selling out each night, you know, with like 1,000 people each night. I was out there for KSCO, and after they'd already booked the big Boardwalk Speaking Center, really beautiful town. I mean, if I lived in California, it'd be there. I've been all over California. And they just, the police, the Boardwalk police, they said, we're going to run security or this event isn't going to happen. And then they groped everybody. And they were real nice to me, treating me like I was the president. And I can see how the elite gets into this, because, I mean, there's like 10 cops around me, and they're being super nice and everything. But I was like, well, I guess I'll do the event, but I don't like you doing the groping. That's the way it is. So that's the problem we face, sir. Aryans in this country are absolutely, totally out of control. And I want to escape from the New World Order. But there's nowhere to run. It's global. We've got to take our countries respectively back. I am fighting from here in the former United States of America, now captured by the global mega crime syndicate known as the New World Order. You must fight in your area against these people. It is a corporate stealth takeover, very hard to beat, because it's not an enemy openly carrying its banner. More and more, though, they're announcing they've conquered us in their financial prospectuses to investors. Bloomberg News, you name it, they brag we've been conquered and laugh how we'll never get out of it. They're going to tell us what to eat. They're going to tell us what to do. They're going to tell us what to think. You go to drudgereport.com. There are just scores of articles up there. And I want my guys to do some boil downs on this as well. We're all over the United States, but also in Europe, they're banning the Christmas tree. I can't think of anything more beautiful than a big tree with blue lights, with green lights, with white lights. I mean, we've got the most beautiful Christmas tree that we then grind up and turn into mulch for the politically correct out there. The most beautiful Christmas tree ever. Just the way my wife decorated it, it's just so beautiful in our living room. And I'm looking at the one on Drudge Report, just a big, towering, beautiful white and blue tree with a big star up on top of it. And you can have Muslim symbols, you can have Buddhist symbols, you can have menorahs. You can't have crosses. They're pulling them down off hilltops, mountains. Churches are taking them out, saying it offends people that come into the churches. That's now been confirmed. And everywhere, they're telling children they can't say Christmas. Folks, even if you believe the official separation of church and state means in any government facility, but the government's taking everything over, you can't have them officially do something, children are allowed to say, I'm a Christian or I'm an atheist. And a lot of the atheists out there are like, yay, shut down their free speech. Folks, the Christmas tree, if you really want to get technical, is an extremely druidic pagan symbol. But I don't think it's evil just because it's a symbol of deep in the winter, the evergreen doesn't die and the sun will come back. You imagine people in Northern Europe when for months there's no light and, you know, they get in there with a fire and an evergreen tree and go, oh, please come back green. I mean, you know, sure, it's pagan, but I don't think dark paganism. Okay, I mean, it's a tree. It's a green tree. And you're not worshiping it. I mean, if you go look at the original development in anthropology and archaeology, where it comes from, cultures all over the north, including Asians, in northern China, Tibetans, green trees, bring them into the house in the winter. I mean, I love the smell of the Christmas tree. So the idiot pagans who operate and pose as atheists, because that's what a bunch of them are, I've actually found. They're so stupid. They want, now obviously Christians took it, put lights on it, made it about Christ's birth, whatever. Things are only bad if you project that onto them. It's like every symbol out there has been taken and turned into something evil. The all-seeing eye, the pyramid, the circle, the rising sun. The New World Order has every symbol. People can say, oh, an eagle is a symbol of, you know, evil. No, it's evil if that's what you do under its banner. It's like our flag now is a symbol of evil worldwide. But the American flag has been taken, expropriated, stolen. Our colors have been stolen. We have to bring it back and say what it really symbolizes. But that said, I'm going to get into this after I go to calls. Seniors decry ban on Christmas tree in their complex in Newhall, LA Daily News. And folks, these people sue when you're saying no one at the commencement speech can get up and say thank God, or football players can't kneel and thank God. Folks, you're an individual. It's your speech. You have free speech to get up there and say, I love the devil, or I love Jesus Christ, or I don't believe in any of it, or I worship aliens from planet Google snop. I mean, I worship Santa Claus. Well, okay, you can get up there and say what you want. And guys, will you put the text of the First Amendment on screen for me? Thank you. Let me read this to you. And every order of a DVD, a book, a T-shirt gets a free citizen rule book. Okay? Every order. And I assure you it's not a conspiracy theory. This does exist. Because they say everything we talk about doesn't exist. It does. It is the First Amendment. The first. Not the second. Not the third. Not the fourth. Not the fifth. Not the sixth. Not the seventh. Not the eighth. Not the ninth. Not the tenth. It is the first. Congress shall make no law respecting an establishment of religion or prohibiting the free exercise thereof, or abridging the freedom of speech or the press of the right of the people to peaceably assemble and to petition the government for a redress of grievances. In there is the right of scumbags to take a crucifix, put it in a glass of urine, take photos and sell it all day. Or to put manure all over the Virgin Mary and sell it to degenerates. Because if those degenerates lose their right, I lose my right. To sit here and go, you people are a bunch of control freak, Jacobin tyrants that ran the French Revolution out of the Illuminati mainline history that no one even knows. And Thomas Jefferson, who's used to destroy liberty by the socialist and the Marxist and the cultural Marxist who work for the bankers. It's just so incredible. They are the people that are lying to everyone about Thomas Jefferson. You can look up. We ought to do a piece on this. I've done pieces years ago on it. Thomas Jefferson, in debates in letters about states that were trying to create their own state-run religion, saying you can't make a state Baptist, you can't make a state Catholic, you cannot have an official state, and you cannot have the state announcing an official thing and putting money into it. But instead, what's Obama push? He pushes faith-based initiative to give billions to churches to control them. That is a violation of the Constitution, the Bill of Rights, the Declaration of Independence, and separation of church and state. See, Christians argue there is no separation of church and state because they're ignorant. Or at least the people on radio, none of them understand it. It's all clear, so easy to understand, and the courts understand it. That's why they keep overturning all this, but the system doesn't care. So, if you went to a public school and your teacher got up and said, today we're going to pray to Jesus, that would be wrong. Because that's up to your preacher and who they are. But see, it's wrong to have a public school to begin with. You should be in a local community school where the community decides what's in it. So see, it's the chicken or the egg. People say, let's bring prayer back into schools. Well, that's whatever the government decided the prayer should be. Christ said pray in your prayer closet, not up on the hill like a Pharisee in front of everybody. But the point here is it's very sophisticated. It's complex. Reality is three-dimensional, four-dimensional. It has edges. It has depth. It has smell. It has a taste. I'm going to your calls. I start talking about this, and it makes my brain burn, because Congress shall make no law respecting an establishment of religion. That's how it starts. Congress can make no law. States can make no law. You do not have a jurisdiction. That's why Native American tribes can take hallucinogens like peyote buttons, and the feds used to try to arrest them. You can't stop them. They've been doing it for 10,000 years. You can't stop them. It's their religion. Just like Christians drink red wine and believe it transmutes the blood of Christ. To go back to that moment there. You can't stop them under religion giving a thimble of red wine to a two-year-old. Because it's the parental right and the religious right. And you can't stop people doing voodoo ceremonies, chopping the head off of a goat, even though we find it distasteful. Because there is a First Amendment. You understand that. But when you cross the line and hurt an individual, then that's not your religious right. Okay? So the government has no jurisdiction. And then there is the basic. Our founders did say we were founded as a Christian nation. And they, again, they're selectively enforcing against Christian iconography and Christian symbols. Really, the globalists hate the fact that Christians took from the pagan the tree. People say, well, then the tree must be evil. No, we took it. See, it's so amazing. It'd be like if a book had a terrible cover on it, but you pulled out the bad stuff and put something else in it, you see. I'll go to your calls. The point is, telling children they can't give people Christmas cards, and that's done nationwide, telling children they can't bring a Bible in their bag, but they can bring a Harry Potter book that is religion. That's a religion, folks. That's there to sell paganism on record. It's wrong, and it's selectively enforced. And why are they going after Christianity? Because real Christianity, not what's taught in the government-run churches now, real Christianity stands diametrically opposed to the New World Order. That's why. And Congress can make no law on any of these issues, not your speech, not your assembly, not your petition for redress of grievances. Your free speech shall not be abridged. And what is it? Congress shall make no law respecting an establishment of religion or prohibiting the free exercise thereof. Here, let's read it again. It's like throwing holy water on a vampire to these people. Congress shall make no law respecting an establishment of religion or prohibiting the free exercise thereof, or abridging the freedom of speech or the press, or the right of the people to peaceably assemble and petition the government for redress of grievances. But also, the globalists want everything to be ugly. They love ugliness. We've talked about this with a lot of experts here, and they just hate the idea of bringing light to darkness. They hate the beauty and the simplicity of decorating a tree. They absolutely hate the cheer that comes out of Christmas. That's why they tried to superimpose Santa Claus with Coca-Cola in the 20s and 30s. That's why they tried to superimpose on All Hallows Eve, the demonic Samhain, satanic holiday. Everything good, they project something bad onto it, ugliness, because they want to make you ugly in your soul and your mind, because then you won't recognize their ugliness, their evil. They want to muddy the water like a squid shoots out ink so that you don't see them, the big lurking razor-sharp-toothed eel in the night. Let's go to your calls. I apologize. I always say I'm going to them, and I never can. Let's move quickly here. John? No, he's not. Marcos is up next. Marcos in North Carolina, you're on the air.
Hi, Alex. How's it going?
Good, sir. Thanks for holding. Go ahead.
Thanks. My fiance Katie and I started Greater Raleigh Resistance on Planet InfoWars, and we decided to fight fluoride. We've built a coalition with Durham Against Fluoride and FoundersTruth.org, and this past Tuesday, December 4th, we went to our fourth monthly fluoride fighting Tuesday, and the dissociation from reality in this country is so pronounced, there are members of the city council that actually toasted the mass poisoning of citizens through water fluoridation. It's crazy. The video can be found at YouTube on Toxic NC Water. Articles are Planet InfoWars and at Durham Against Fluoride. And I just wanted to say, activists, the platform Planet InfoWars works. You got to use it and then get up, get out, and be heard. And
yeah, I've really dropped the ball promoting PlanetInfoWars.com. It's grown. It's getting big. But I need to post more of its stories on PrisonPlanet.com and InfoWars.com. And I need to. There's amazing articles, amazing photos, amazing research. The art department of the magazine is now putting all the art we produce up on an art section. I need to get the URL of that and start plugging it. That's part of it. But thank you, sir. Good to hear from you. Let's go to Jeff in Georgia on Benghazi and the whole Obama cover-up of that, I would imagine. Jeff, welcome.
Hey, Dallas, first-time caller. Thanks for having me. Very excited to be here.
Great to have you, brother.
Every day, just to get the real news that's out there. And just to dovetail on what you were finishing talking about there, I'm just in here looking. I just dragged out of my basement my end-of-December tree that I'm going to decorate with some light fixtures to symbolize my my belief in it, in my end-of-December belief.
Well, I mean, whatever it is, you know, the point is they want to set the precedent to go after Christians. Why is that? They want to shut down Christmas. Why is that?
Well, I guess it's just because it brings us together. There's a certain unity that comes from that. If we were all to unite really under the Christmas spirit, we could really actually do something.
That's it. That's it. It is the story of Scrooge. They've replaced it with commercialism and the opposite. And so they're attacking it, trying to remove the old Christmas and bring in their new World Order Christmas. Well, what did you originally call about? Go ahead.
It's, like I said, I was going to talk about Benghazi, and something just kind of hangs in my craw here a little bit is a couple weeks ago when Fox was really chasing it, and they came out with a couple special reports over the weekend. It was the second one with Greg Palcott. He goes through a tour of the Benghazi, quote-unquote, consulate, which is really just a villa where they were running CIA ops. And they, you know, he's trying to do the timeline, and they show the inside of the consulate, and they show that the ambassador supposedly was putting himself into a safe room within this the annex of that building, and they're showing it, and basically it's a jail cell. It's like, you know, if anybody's seen a safe room or the movie Safe Room, that's a place where
it's a giant armored door. Yeah, no, they spun it. It's now been admitted that it was a CIA torture base, and there was a bigger one down the street, and that's the big scandal. Obama is still torturing 24/7. And they're torturing anti-Al-Qaeda people in the area. Again, our government runs Al-Qaeda.
Right, I agree.
What do you think of the admissions that our government runs Al-Qaeda?
And they put it back in our face that the CIA said, remember they put the statement out saying we've been out of the detention business since January 20th, 2009, when Obama was inaugurated, just to say, hey, we're not doing that. But of course they're doing that. It's every, like you said, right is up. Wrong is down. Every single thing that these guys have done, they just continue to do.
Well, let me tell you, waterboarding is bad, and pulling fingernails out is bad. But man, they're doing stuff, hurting little kids in front of their parents. I mean, It freaks me out to think how evil these people are. I mean, let me tell you, because that's how evil works. The worst of the worst keep replacing the last worst guy until you get to the very most evil in charge. And they just like hurting children. Have you read the Army's report about all the kids they torture? Little kids.
Yeah, I try not to even read that because there's so many other foul things to look at in this world. That's one of the ones that just...
No, no, I agree with you, but people should go read the Army's report on just Abu Ghraib and the little kids. Because, folks, they didn't just torture them. They Jerry Sandusky'd them. Well, Sandusky didn't ripe them with battery acid. Thank you for the call, sir. I appreciate you. Yeah. Yeah. That's not our government, folks. That's foreign banker criminals that run things. Oh, Alex, don't say the rest of the Penn State was involved. Remember a year ago and everything came out? I was right. Oh, the whole top echelon covered it up. And you know why? You know why, don't you? Let's go. The guy's raping people in the middle of the day in a field house. Those are like an airport. You ever been in a college field house? I have. It's like an airport. That's a pedophile command base. Let's go ahead and talk to Jared in Colorado. Jared, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Hey, Alex, it's Jared, and I'm calling from Pima Region 8. It's an honor to speak with you. I've been listening to you for over 2 years now. I remember 2 years ago, I'm actually calling with 2 points. On the first one, I remember 2 years ago when I first started listening to you, I was really programmed and a zombie from television and sports and everything. And then just listening to you, you really woke me up to guns and the Constitution and freedom and liberty, and I give my sincere gratitude and truly thank you for everything you've done for me and the people who I've influenced as well.
Brother, listen, you know, Limbaugh used to say when folks were thanking him, just say dittos. Believe me, I appreciate you putting up with me, and I appreciate you out there fighting the tyranny, and God bless you. Please don't thank me. What do you want to talk about today?
Thank you. I'm actually at work right now. I'm working at a dispensary in FEMA Region 8 in Denver, Colorado. We just passed Amendment 64, and I was reading on your website that the UN was actually thinking about coming in, stepping in, and overturning Amendment 64, saying that it would be a bad message for the rest of the world. Do you think that is actually going to pass? They're actually going to try to come in and overturn Amendment 64 and the law that was passed in Washington as well?
I don't know what's going to happen with that. We're going to have to watch. What do you think?
Okay. I'm hoping for the 10th Amendment of the Constitution, states' rights. I think that the people of Colorado have voted, and it's what we want. So,
I agree with you, and it's clearly states' rights to legalize marijuana. I'm not necessarily saying it's good to even, you know, use marijuana. It has a lot of medical uses, but for getting high, it does hurt a lot of people. I'll talk about it when I come back. If you've given show, military is flying drones throughout U.S. Yeah, they're arresting citizens in North Dakota and California with them. DARPA flying Reaper drones that surveil entire cities in real time. I saw a drone, a Global Hawk, about a month ago. And by the time I tried to get a photo, it was out of range. But they're just taking our money and building a robot force against us. Speaking of Sandusky, he's in the news. He wants his pension. He says that's his money. What a degenerate. Unbelievable. Trial hearing delayed for Penn State administrators. Yeah, they'll all get off. Unbelievable. But that's what they do. Doomsday prepper raided by police, FBI, after criticizing Obama. And Watson was doing research on this today and found a bunch of other cases that just happened. They're now getting search warrants saying you're a terrorist if you criticize Obama. And if we give into the fear of this, it's all over. We got to double down speaking out against them. You know, they tried to say you couldn't film federal buildings. They've lost a bunch of lawsuits. They're now backing off. And that video should be ready today for the nightly news. We're going to premiere a Joe Rogan interview tonight as well. It's very powerful. Ron Paul, the film, which is just images and documentation added to his farewell speech, is up at InfoWars.com. It's extremely powerful as well. We premiered that last night at InfoWarsNightlyNews.com. Okay, let's go back to the calls in this segment, the next, then Gerald Celente. John in Florida wants to talk about the takeover of the churches, what Pastor Lindsey Williams' source calls the Devil's Messiah program. Go ahead.
Yes, thank you, Alex. I'm deeply concerned about the timeline and the actual methods by which they're using to do that. How do I recognize that I'm involved in my religion? And I'm just curious to be able to recognize that it's happening. I know that they're against organized religion. I know the UN has a plan to do away with religion. I'm just not familiar.
Well, no. I mean, they openly announced they want a one-world Gaia religion where you've got to subscribe to that. You can still call yourself Baptist or Catholic or Jewish or whatever, but you will submit to the new global religion. And even the Pope's been going along with that. Go ahead.
Interesting. Well, and the timeline, if you don't mind, any idea what kind of time frame they're hoping for this mass conversion into this new religion or doing away with old religions?
Well, what they're going to do is they're going to create giant sectarian religious wars out of the Christian, Jewish, Muslim clash. They plan to bring in, as Albert Pike said, the world government after a giant war. So it'll still take them time, and they're between 7 and 10 years behind. But they're doing it. I mean, I go to dinner with friends and family, and they go, yeah, they've taken the cross out of the church, and they say it'll offend people. And we're talking mainline churches. And I need to go out and actually show this happening. I mean, you know, I've got family that, you know, it goes and visits a church, and they're told, you know, the Bill and Melinda Gates are our savior, basically, and we got to pay them money. You know, I mean, it's everywhere. They've taken most of the churches over. When Congress shall make no law respecting an establishment of religion or prohibiting the free exercise thereof. Churches led the Revolutionary War against the British. Churches should be speaking out against politicians. But instead, they're like, we're not allowed to talk about government, separation of church and state. No. Government can't talk about you. You can do whatever you want. I mean, it's so clear. And that's what we had in this country till 50, 60 years ago with the 501c3. It's the key. Because they get people to opt in. They get you to opt. Oh, you got to get a license to be a commercial driver. You opt in to waive your rights. Then they tell everybody they have no rights. You see what I'm saying? They get churches to opt in and become charities, not churches. It's all bait and switch scams. We're just a trusting, lemming public going off the edge of the cliff. You know how easy it was to go pay off all the denomination leaders and give them money through the Rockefeller Foundation? I mean, that's how they did it. Anything else?
Well, I want to tell you, you are a dynamic individual, and thank you very much.
Oh, please. What I am is somebody who might have a death wish. And I'm being a little sarcastic. I love life so much, I'm ready to give mine up, because there will be no future if we don't beat these people. We will continue with your calls in this segment, and those of you that are holding, you're going to get to talk to Gerald Celente. Just address your comments or questions to him, because he's pretty much in the same vein as we are on many fronts. Smart guy, so... Once we get to your calls, after he talks about 30 minutes, just to have a question for him, or you can hang up and somebody else can get on board. I'm about to talk to Christina and some others that are patiently holding, and then we'll continue to go through a whole cornucopia of news with Gerald Celente, a bunch of key topics coming up in the next segment. But first off, let's go to Christina in Texas on the Second Amendment. Hey, Bob Costas doubled and tripled down. He says men should not be able to own guns. Ages 20 to 30, we cannot be trusted. What do you make of that, Christina?
I only own one gun right now, but plan on getting a few. My boyfriend has several, so we're kind of keeping an eye on
Well, I hope he's not 20 to 30 years old. Bob Costas says those are bad people. Men are bad.
I'm actually 30. He's 8 years older than me.
Oh, well, good. You can't have 30-year-olds with guns. Good. Bob Costas said so, a little runt. Sorry, go ahead.
No, I had heard something several months ago, and I've been trying to find information on it, and I can't really. Something about after they take the guns, the UN goes through and starts taking the guns, that they might send troops in through the Texas border to get into
the U.S. Look, it won't be a sneak attack. They've got police exchange programs where they send our police over to Europe and then come over here to Japan, vice versa. To where you'll be arrested under international law and taken to The Hague for your free speech and drug off. And they're just acclimating our troops when you now hear about NATO deaths in Afghanistan. So it'll just be that foreign troops are phased into our military. In LE09, they started publicly admitting troops from 15 nations here training to, quote, back up American forces under NORTHCOM if terrorist attack. And it listed them as domestic extremists. And they drilled not to fight Muslim extremists. That's for the public consumption. They drill to fight veterans. I can show you the New York Times on that. They drill to kill veterans. So that's how it'll work. It won't be UN troops show up like Red Dawn. It's that, you know, these are, we got footage in Chicago of foreign troops training with our military to put citizens in the sports dome.
A couple of years back when she was living in Livingston in Texas, she told me about y'all's show. And at the time, unfortunately, I was working for a private ICE facility in Livingston right next to the Polonsky unit. I worked for TVC for a while as well. And it took me several years after I got severely hurt on that unit. I almost died from an inmate assault. Oddly enough, we were shorthanded that night. And I also refused to forge paperwork. I wouldn't forge any paperwork. I wouldn't forge any documents and say I did it. So, and I had called them and let them know something was wrong, and nobody came down. And I ended up with a broken jaw in two places and almost had my throat split open.
Well, that's what they do. They probably told the, I mean, statistically, they probably sent the inmate to kill you.
Yeah, that's, now that I'm out of the system and I'm, the programming is taken and run its course with the help of family. It took me a while.
Well, you know, I mean, you know, the big private prisons, that's the model. They put the gangs in charge and then let them sell the drugs to everybody, and it's totally corrupt, and then the jail guards don't have to really do anything. I mean, that's the model, and then that's a new enforcement army. Those are colleges to roll those gangs out against the American people, and then they work for the feds. That's on record. Max Kaiser's written about it, but, I mean, it's on record. And I don't know about those ICE units, but that's pretty much par for the course. I mean, that's like Serpico. He wouldn't take drug money and stuff. All the other detectives were on drugs, you know, drug money and other things. Because once you do that, why not do other stuff? And, you know, they shot him in the face. So that's what they do. A lot of departments aren't that corrupt, but big city ones generally are. I've got to say, I don't have evidence the Austin Police Department is a mafia, which is very rare in big cities. And you can't have a Christmas tree either. And you got to get that.
From enemies, foreign and domestic, it's Alex Jones.
Only I can interrupt myself. I actually do that. Sometimes we're playing a report I've done, and then I'll be interrupting, stopping my own reporter, talking over myself. I don't know. I just think about stuff. I want to talk about it. Yeah, that's right. You didn't build that, and you're not allowed to have a Christmas tree. Even in your front yard now, they say it offends people, so it's got to go. It's evil. First Amendment, though, says you can do whatever you want, religious. Instead, the government's violating the First Amendment with faith-based initiative, tens of billions of dollars a year, to fund and control your churches. That is unconstitutional. Congress shall make no law respecting an establishment of religion or prohibiting the free exercise thereof. For the rest of the hour, maybe 5 minutes of overdrive, we are joined by Gerald Celente. You can go online and you can see his different websites, GeraldCelente.com, TrendsResearch.com, TrendsJournal.com. They all take you to the same place, an amazing website. You can see there, if you type in Gerald Celente, who do people associate with Gerald Celente? Alex Jones, Peter Schiff, Mark Faber, Max Kaiser, and Jim Rogers. And that is, I agree with all those guys. That is quite, it's good to be in that company. Because I was just typing in Gerald Celente to see the latest news on him during the break and noticed that I'm honored to be up there. I think out of all those people, the most with Gerald Celente and Max Kaiser. Jim Rogers is a great guy. And of course, those Mark Faber and Peter Schiff. But side issue, he joins us now. He publishes the Trends Journal with the great artwork of Anthony Frieda and others. And he's one of the few people that I just constantly learn things from. I mean, because I can learn a lot from other people, but it's just like, wow, a big dose of that. And it'll make my mother happy. I know who listens. We've kind of done an informal poll. I think Gerald Celente, I don't think I know, is the most popular guest on this show. So without further ado, I'm going to shut up. You know, Gerald asked, hey, what topics do you want me on about via email? And I said, hey, why don't you send the topics? So we're going to go through the topics he wants to cover, and a bunch of these are what I would have covered already. So I'm glad we're of one mind on many fronts. I guess minds that love freedom think the same, think alike. And we'll go through some of these points. Gerald, everything is accelerating. Just as you predicted in Europe, they have these fake fiscal cliffs to then terrorize everyone into more banker bailout money as the bankers exempt themselves. You wanted to get into the fiscal cliff first, The Republicans want a rapist five ways to Sunday, and Obama wants it seven ways to Sunday. You know, I'm nonpartisan, but Obama really wants even more taxes and dictatorial power handed over to him. What's your take on the fiscal cliff, Gerald?
Well, first of all, you know, we've been hearing about this fiscal cliff now, what? This is about a week before election day. It's going on over a month. And, you know, the toilet paper of record, the New York Times, calls what I do pessimism porn when I warn about something. But boy, are they selling pessimism porn with this fiscal cliff. You can't get it out of your head. They're hitting every hour, every day with it. And they're making a lot more out of it than it is. Because it's not just the fiscal cliff. It's a much bigger story than that, but they're not telling the whole story. And the story is this. They synthesized it down that, well, you know, we'll go over the fiscal cliff if we don't cut the budget deficit, the federal budget deficit, because it's out of line. And the way we're going to do it is, oh, we have two ideas. Because we're only the Republicans and the Democrats, we can only come up with two ideas because we're too damn stupid to think of anything more. We'll call ourselves the incompetents and the inepts. I got an idea. Let's cut spending. Okay, great. I got another idea. Let's talk about taxes. We'll either increase them or we'll decrease them. That's the end of the story. That's how far these morons go. Why don't we talk about the whole issue here? If you're going to cut spending and you're going to increase taxes, guess what you're going to do, moron? You're going to slow down the economy. Hey, the economy's not slowing down enough for you? Let's really put the brakes on it. Then what does it do? Well, 70% of the GDP in the United States is consumer spending. 70%. Yeah, that's right, because they sold out the country. They offshored our manufacturing. You remember it. Bill Clinton, that wonderful liberal. Yeah, the debate with Ross Perot and Al Gore. Yeah. Oh, we're going to have great jobs. We don't need those manufacturing jobs. We can have service sector jobs. Oh, service sector. Service, servitude. Right. You get to be a cashier. You could stock shelves at Walmart. Oh, you could be on a call center, the ones that we still have here that they haven't shipped to India or the Philippines. So now you're going to cut spending, you're going to increase taxes, you're going to slow down the economy, less people work, less tax revenues come in. Brilliant. So how are we going to solve this problem? It's very simple, and no one will talk about it. Why won't they talk about it? Because of the Gambinos and the Bananos, the two crime families that made these problems happen. So how could any imbecile, any thinking person, look upon the people that caused the problem to solve it? They can't. The way you solve it is, number one, bring the jobs back home. Put back in place what Bill Clinton took away from us, what George W. Bush accelerated, and what Obama keeps going by bragging that we're making up more trade deals there. Oh, yeah, you know what a trade deal is? Very simple. Hey, how about that lovely fire over there in Bangladesh that killed over 100 people in the sweatshop? A trade deal means you take all of your manufacturing, anything that service, anything that you could do, bring it to a slave labor country, and then bring it back and mark the price up.
That actually brings down those countries. Almost all the studies show then you destroy Mexico, they kick them off their agrarian land, then they all come up here, drive down the wages even more, and the globalists brag it's a consolidation, a race to the bottom. They know what they're doing. But Al Gore got up in 94 in those debates with Ross Perot and Larry King, and they all laughed at Ross Perot when he said it was a giant sucking sound. But guess what it was? And then they have tax incentives to move the jobs overseas, and they spend $21, $22 billion to move Cadillac and Volt factories to China and Brazil. And that's a good deal, Gerald. They're going to bail out General Motors by moving it overseas. I mean, they are gutting this country.
Exactly. So the fiscal cliff is a lot of crap. That's what I'm trying to say. And you nailed it. You put all the details into it. So the first one is that. The second one is put back the regulations that gave this the people in this country an even shot at the deal. And those regulations, you know, from the 19th to the 20th century, the robber barons were taking over the country. Now they just got different names. They got names like private equity groups, hedge funds, yeah, BlackRock, Goldman Sachs gang, all of these companies that have taken over all the whole country, whether it's in retail, whether it's in agriculture, whether it's in communication.
And they take the money they suck and move it to a third world hell pit to sell us junk back to dig the hole deeper. They're waging economic war against us.
They're enslaving us. It's a plantation economy. That's all it is. You're looking, I'm not making this up. You look at the numbers, Alex. What, median household income has fallen over 10% since the Great Recession began in 2008? I'm not making it up that 50% of the kids that get with college degrees that get jobs are making jobs that are paying wages that you could get with a high school diploma and that you can't live on. I'm not making it up. So when you look at what they've done, hey, you know, when I was a kid, they had this strange thing. They used to have pharmacies on the corner that were owned by people in the community. There were no Rite Aids or Walgreens. There were no Duane Reeds or CVS's clogging up every corner. Everybody had a shot at it until the politicians got paid off to deregulate. They deregulated the Robinson-Patman Act. They deregulated the Sherman Antitrust Act. They deregulated the Clayton Antitrust Act. And what did they do? Oh, under Bill Clinton again? Yeah, you know, the one that everybody loves. Oh, just a little side note. I heard Obama during the campaign. He kept saying, you know, under Bill Clinton, we created 23 million jobs, his government did. B.S. The reason we had 23 million jobs back then, for anybody that's old enough to remember, you mentioned 1994, that was the beginning of the internet revolution, the dot-com bubble. It was a whole new world was being born. But I digress. Bill Clinton is the guy that under the other member of the Goldman Sachs gang, Robert Rubin, began the process of deregulating the economy on the financial end by killing the Glass-Steagall Act that was put in place during the Great Depression so that the banks couldn't rob all our money by making up all of these games to steal it from us from everywhere we could look at. So those are two ways to solve the fiscal problem. The third, very simple, and this is one of the big trends. It's going to be the major major trend of 2013. They're taking us to war. Eisenhower said it. I keep saying it over again. Five-star general, supreme commander of the Allied forces during World War II. He warned us. Oh, two-term Republican president, I forgot. He warned us that and no major wars were fought when he was president. You know why? Because he was a man. He was a man that saw death and destruction. He was a man that fought, not like these little boys with cojones.
Stay there. Let's come back. The carrier and the invasion force is getting ready. They're off the coast of Syria. It's Gerald Celente, this question. If you just tuned in, you're listening to The Alex Jones Show. I'm Alex Jones. Our news sites are Infowars.com, and we stream video at PrisonPlanet.tv and InfowarsNews.com. TrendsResearch.com is Gerald's excellent site. If you want to be successful and know what's coming before it gets there, turn a little bit of football off, a little bit of the sitcom off, and go check out the powerful information. It's actually fun to be informed. People have been taught that it's fun to be stupid, and actually it's not being... Being stupid means you're going to be poor and your family's not going to be in a bad position. I just can't imagine. You know, manliness is being informed, being involved, and being in charge of your own destiny as much as you can. Same thing for women. But side issue, going back to Gerald. Gerald, it is now in articles in McClatchy News, LA Times, you name it, Drudge Report. Matt Drudge tweeted out oh, look, now you're going to go, you know, and have WMD hysteria and lies before the UN saying Syria is going to use their chemical weapons, which they admit they have. They haven't attacked anybody. The West for 21 months is using Al-Qaeda against them. And now the news admits what we've known for a while. Our government is putting Al-Qaeda in with NATO. The French are massing ships. The British are. There's a U.S. aircraft carrier and three amphibious landing ships, which they don't. I mean, this is insane. And they're now saying, we need action because Assad is hurting people. While our government is on record, Al-Qaeda is being put in where they tell fathers, we're going to kill you if you don't go suicide bomb. And the news, remember the New York Times a few months ago ran with some stories about that and then pulled it, their own video because they thought, oh, look, they're making people suicide bomb. They're the good rebels. Thinking we would go, oh, yeah, that's very moral. Kind of like when Rumsfeld was going, yeah, we're torturing people. And people are like, really, that's illegal. Oh, actually, I didn't mean that. I mean, it's bizarro. Even the Nazis didn't admit they were torturing people. I mean, are we not reaching some type of insanity of the ruling class themselves? I mean, what's going on here, Gerald?
I think you just said it. It's insanity. And it's insanity to believe for one second that the so-called ruling class, the officials, the administrators, the presidents, the prime ministers, their cabinets and war ministers know what they're doing. They failed in Afghanistan. They failed in Iraq. Look at that wonderful humanitarian mission that they pulled off in Libya. Oh, that was a beaut. Isn't the freedom and democracy ringing so beautifully? And now, as you mentioned, they're gearing up to go into Syria. And that's where I was going with Eisenhower. Warning that the military-industrial complex was taking over the nation, and that if you want to avoid going over this fiscal cliff, try this one on for size. Didn't the Senate just vote a couple of days ago, 98-0, for a $631 billion defense budget? 98-0. Hey, we got wars to fight.
And by the way, I believe that was there's going to be supplemental as well. It's over. It's almost $2 trillion, all the different spending. This is insane. You cut that by a third, problem solved. I mean, they've got to do it.
Exactly. But what are they doing? Well, they're blowing each other up over there in Detroit with AK-47s, you know, robbing gas stations. The country's, you know, every day you pick up the paper and you see all this crime. And by the way, what's going on in Europe that's not making the news here? My God, the crime rate in Spain, in Greece, the poverty that the people are living in, how this thing is collapsing in front of us. I got an idea. Let's start another war. So as you were saying, yes, it is insanity. How can you expect, again, the same people that caused the problems to fix them? They failed in all these other wars, and now they're going to start another failure. And I want to pick up on what you said. The story back in Iraq was, hey, remember that Saddam Hussein? Yeah, that guy had weapons of mass destruction. I saw that little coward, that Colin Powell. Yeah, Colin, you got the right place, man. Right in that colon, putting on that cheap show in the UN to tell us, hey, look at those pictures. I'll tell you what them is. Those are mobile chemical laboratories. Oh, yeah, you remember how they sold us the lie that Saddam Hussein had weapons of mass destruction? It's playing a parallel right now. It's only different. Now they're saying Syria is going to use their chemical weapons. Before they said, even though Hussein and all his other people and even some weapons inspectors said, hey, listen, man, there are no weapons of mass destruction. The big lie from the U.S. was he has to prove that he doesn't have them.
All right.
What you don't have.
Exactly. That was a short segment, long segment coming up. Gerald Celente is our guest. If you want to talk to him on air, 800-259-9231. We'll continue to talk about where this war will lead us. Straight ahead. Stay with us. All right. Gerald Celente is our guest, and we are going right back to him to race through There's a couple more pages of great points he wants to make. Let's continue to go through your trends, because the war that you've been saying for several years would come, it's definitely going on. Proxy wars, big wars, they just call them peace because Obama is a Peace Prize winner. It's all part of the sick joke. The torture continues. They documented that in Benghazi. There's evidence there was election fraud. I'm not saying it doesn't, you know, that Romney would have saved us. It was just the fix was in at every level. This is not a mandate for everything Obama's doing. Nothing but lobbyists, nothing but signing statements, giant scams, waivers to his buddies from all his laws, saying he'll take guns without congressional approval, shutting down power plants without congressional approval, signing a cybersecurity act and not letting Congress see it, but then the UN brags it gives them the internet. I mean, things are exponentially moving quicker to the point of I think I've gotten punch drunk and almost, you know, I am in a learned helplessness state because and I'm informed and it's just getting crazier by the minute. How crazy will it be in another year, in 3 years, if we continue down this road and the bankers are so arrogant? They're all over the news going, we conquered America. I listen to Bloomberg on XM all the time, driving home at night. And they'll be going, don't worry, we'll get a third bailout for ourselves out of Europe. We're taking over America. There's no way. We've got all the pension funds tied up in what we're doing. We're telling all, you know, the Goldman Sachs, JP Morgan people. They have all these head guys on bragging how they've got us by the short hairs, just bragging how they're setting up a corporate world government. CNBC, AP, Reuters. You read. I mean, my crew's been up there 3-4 times to meet with you. I've met you in New York, but why are they brag? I mean, I know you worked around the white shoe boys. I mean, I guess they are the classic criminals because they brag about it on top of it. Gerald, I'm ranting. Go ahead.
Well, they're sociopaths, and that's the way they behave. And they're money junkies, just like any other junkie, whether you're on heroin or cocaine, whatever it might be. You don't care. You just want to get your fix. And then you know the kind of head that a junkie has. That's all they are. They're no more than that, no less than that. And I just want to stay on Syria for one moment, because they're doing in Iraq with Syria. They're asking them to prove the unprovable. And the unprovable with Syria is, are they going to use these chemical weapons against their people or against other countries? And they're using that as an excuse for preemptive attack, just like they did with Iraq.
That's like saying, Russia, we've got to attack you because you might attack us someday. That's what Hitler did.
Exactly. Well, that's what Bush did with Iraq. They attacked a country that said that they didn't have what America and England and the coalition of the willing said they had. They said, we don't have them. The weapons inspector said, we can't find them. Oh, you can't find them because he won't give them to you. So it's this lunacy. It began what you said. Are they insane? Yes. And what I'm talking about and I've been saying and I'm most concerned about is the first great war of the 21st century. But before I go into that, I also want to pick up on what you said about Obama getting reelected. And I've been around this thing a long time. I've never seen an election that ended with such a thud like this one. The bloom was off the rose immediately. There was no post-election high. The Dow dove about 300 points. Gold prices shot up 50 points. Since that time, the world equity markets have been on a downdraft. Then it was the clips with General Petraeus. You remember him? That guy with the Boy Scouts charm, as the toilet paper or record refers to him as. We have never seen a post-election dive emotionally, spiritually, financially, like we're witnessing now, and then go back into the war.
By the way, they can't even, just real quick, they can't, just to back you up, they can't even sell inaugural tickets, none of them. They can't sell hotel rooms. He's so unpopular, but the system knows, again, they rigged it with Romney too. It's he didn't even get elected. I mean, I've talked to Bev Harris, all the experts. They announced, do you really believe, Gerald, that California didn't vote to not label GMO? I mean, give me a break. When polls were showing it for a while, 2-1 for it. I mean, we're now entering just, they are absolutely engaging in a total takeover. I'm sorry.
No, I agree with you. I don't believe California vote at all. Not at all. I mean, come on. You know, you're going to save a couple of pennies by, you know, putting, I mean, who would believe the big companies anyway? So, no, I agree. You know, I don't, nothing they do, I trust. But going back to the Great War, How much more? I'm telling you, Alex, we're watching very closely what's going on in Europe, what's going on in Italy, what's going on in Spain, what's going on in Greece, what's going on in Hungary, what's going on in Slovenia.
The hospitals are shutting down. They're burning, robberies everywhere, basic hygiene at risk in debt-stricken Greek hospitals. People are dumping their kids on the street. It is bedlam, and the bankers are raising taxes, knowing it will put the countries into cardiac arrest so they can buy everything up. It's insane.
It's insane, and it's war. And no one will call a spade a spade.
Economic war.
Of course, it's class warfare. What difference? What do you think the Arab Springs were? We wrote about them before they happened. It wasn't a pro-democracy movement. It was a lot of people that are tired of not having any money while the top of the pyramid's raping everybody else and stealing all the dough. Same in Tunisia, the same everywhere. So now we have a war in Libya. We have a war in Syria. We have a war in Bahrain that doesn't make the news. There's a war in Yemen. There's wars now heating up in Jordan. They're starting to oppose the king. The king. I love it. You can't call kings dictators. No, no, man. And don't say anything bad about them emirs. No, they're not dictators either. So you have all of these dictators that are starting to collapse. You have, as I said, there's class warfare throughout Europe. It's going on. The people are taking to the streets continually. The first great war of the 21st century has begun. And now, when they go into Syria, watch out for an explosion that you're going to start seeing rattle the world. You know, Alex, I have to tell you a quick story. And I'm going to ask my assistant over here to get me that little frame from General Anthony Zinni. I was asked in 2000 to be the keynote speaker at Virginia Military Institute, VMI. You remember, that's the place where Romney went when he announced what his geopolitical and foreign policy strategy would be.
Yes.
I was called down there to be the keynote speaker to talk about what new millennium warfare would look like. This is now 2000. I had written Trends 2000, my national bestseller, a Warner book. Now, here I am telling. Now, the panel, after I speak, included such people as General Anthony Zinni. This is the guy that ran the first Iraq war, the first Gulf War. He was in charge of the troops under Schwarzenegger. He's on the panel. I'm discussing what new millennium warfare will look like. Here's the little note he sent me afterwards. Gerald, thank you for the book and kind note. My mission to the Middle East will continue, but will be difficult. Have a great holiday season. All the best, Tony Zinni. So here I am telling them what new millennium warfare will look like.
Show us the book again. I had something up on screen.
I don't have, no, that was his... Get the book. This is his note to me. And my book was Trends 2000. It was a national bestseller, a huge book.
Sure, no, I read it.
16 different languages. So now they bring me in to talk about new millennium warfare. Remember, the generals are bringing me in at VMI to tell them what new millennium warfare will look like. Because you've all heard the line. The generals are always fighting the last war. So when I talk about the great war of the 21st century, here's what it's going to look like. It's going to look like dirty bombs going off in Manhattan. It'll be new suitcase-sized nukes going off in Atlanta.
And Obama just said that on Monday. He says there's missing nukes.
Missing nukes? I got the whole front of this book of all of the missing weapons of mass destruction and suitcase-sized nukes that was being sold on the black market when the Soviet Union dissolved.
I mean, Alexander Lebed exposed all that, and they blew up his helicopter.
You know, 20 years late. So anyway, you're going to see biological warfare. You're going to see hell. And what they're going to do, as the more of this that happens, the more rights they're going to take away from us under the guise that the psychopaths and sociopaths that started this are now going to save us. Alex, the first major trend of the new Trends Journal coming out, the top trends for 2013, is going to be peace. And I mean that, and we're doing everything, and we think, and I'll be discussing it more, that we have a real peace plan and something to put into place. Because you don't have to listen to me. Look with your eyes. Listen with your ears. Open your mind up. Look what's going on around the world. Look what's going on in this country. You can see it collapsing in front of us. The fiscal cliff? How about the bottomless pit?
Well said. I want to take a few phone calls, as we promised to. We've got you till five after next hour, so just about 15, 20 more minutes left total here with Gerald Celente. And there's a few other important points he needs to get into. But the establishment is digging in for a World War III type scenario. Now, that's exactly all of the intel I get, the stuff, the information I respect in the film we made with Joel Skousen, Strategic Relocation. Max Kaiser calls them suicide bankers, where there were people in the towers who were there during the crisis making money. Even after one tower had collapsed, there were people staying in one, you know, because they were making millions and killing themselves to make extra money. And, you know, these guys have so many billions of dollars apiece. It's all about, because I've read about the way they behave, showing off to the other ones, and that guy's got $20 billion, I've only got $5 billion, and they're selling all this fraud. And then the police, the military, they're all trained just to follow it, and it is a kind of a Caligula-type deal where he marries his horse and, you know, makes it the regent of Rome. How do we stop these people?
Again, you know, I'm going to be talking about this in more detail as we put it, the whole package together. But I want to also pick up what you were saying about the bankers. Again, I'm not making this stuff up. As I mentioned, Robert Rubin was the former CEO of Goldman Sachs Gang, and he was appointed as Treasury Secretary under Clinton as they deregulated the Glass-Steagall Act. The first, one of the big corporations that were created from that was Citigroup. He then ends up getting a job. Citigroup merges with Smith Barney, Travelers Insurance Company, Citibank, puts it all together. Then he becomes a consultant for them. What does he make? Over $100 million. Who was the Treasury Secretary under Bush that gave us TARP and made up the great big lie of too big to fail? Too big to fail are the words too big to fail that destroyed capitalism. This isn't capitalism. In capitalism, nobody's too big to fail. It's fascism, the merger of state and corporate powers. Henry Paulson. Where did Paulson come from? He was the CEO of the Goldman Sachs Gang before becoming Treasury Secretary. Okay, you got it. Two in a row. Then who's the guy that brought down MF Global? And that robbed me and others of their money, can't find $1.6 billion. Oh, that wasn't John the Slime Corzine, former governor and senator of New Jersey. Oh, and before that, the head of the Goldman Sachs Gang. That's right. And who's the head of the Commodities Future Trading Commission? Oh, Gary Gensler. And they never prosecuted or brought Corzine up on charges. Oh, where did he come from? Oh, he worked for Corzine when Corzine was with Goldman Sachs. Oh, Alex, who's the new guy over there that just became the head of the Bank of England? You know, the City of London. The City of London, yeah, there's a kid, that, you know, this is a family show. I can't say what I really want to say, but let's just say the City of London makes Las Vegas look like, you know, kids play. City of London. It's a place where you could do the dirtiest deals at the highest levels. Who became the head of the Bank of England over there? Huh, Mark Carney. Oh, I love that word, Carney. Carney, carnival man. Oh, yeah, this guy's the perfect Carney. Carney. Where did Mark Carney come from? Wasn't he just running the show over here in Canada, the bank over there? Yeah. And now he's the head of the Bank of
England. And by the way, even the outgoing head of the Bank of England, you know, who's a globalist, says this is the equivalent. And in fact, talk about tooting horns. Guys, type in Bank of England head war, and it's a London Guardian article. There's also a Daily Mail one. And he says this financial meltdown is like a new world war. I didn't put the connection to you. I think he's basically saying what you're saying. And he's saying this new guy, that it's like a criminal takeover, basically.
Goldman Sachs takeover. He was with Goldman Sachs. And I'm tired of hearing this word investment banker. These are gamblers on the inside that know the deal and make the money. It ain't because they're so bright. Oh, remember the LIBOR rigging scandal? They rigged interest rates. They rigged everything. Look at the scandal going on now with that other hedge fund. No, so he was not an investment banker. He didn't become a multimillionaire, billionaire because of his brains. You make the money because you're on the inside of the mob. So now the Goldman Sachs gang now is running the Bank of England. Oh, and then I forgot. The European Central Bank. How could I forget that one? Who's running that one? Mario Draghi. Mario Draghi, hey, wasn't he the vice chairman of the Goldman Sachs gang in Europe before becoming appointed to head the European Central Bank? Wasn't he the guy that they blame for bringing Greece into the European Union, the Eurozone?
That's right. It's a total world government, Goldman Sachs, J.P. Morgan Chase takeover. We'll be right back with Gerald Celente and your phone calls. Stay there. We're going to jam in a few calls for Gerald Celente in this little short segment and the next. I just want to add, you can get his great Trends Journal quarterly, but also the Trends updates at trendsresearch.com. Invaluable information for everybody. And you can also support us here and help us in this whole platform when you buy books, videos, the high-quality ProPure water filters discounted at InfoWarsStore.com. You not only get great deals and the best products we find out there, you finance this whole operation. So I want to thank everybody that does buy books, videos, preparedness information, films, T-shirts, ball caps, you name it, at InfoWarsStore.com, and that support all our great sponsors, because we only bring you sponsors that we believe in. So InfoWarsStore.com, and get 15% off the ProPure water filtration systems, the best gravity-fed filters out there, through December 10th. We're doing that so we can guarantee get it all delivered to you way before Christmas. It makes a great gift. Gerald, let's jam in a couple phone calls here. Quick questions. Bert in Illinois, what's your quick question for Gerald Celente, sir?
Well, first of all, I want to thank you and Gerald for your dedication to the cause.
Thank you.
Number one, I don't know if you ever seen the movie.
I didn't hear anything.
Number one, I don't know if you've seen the movie Billy Jack Goes to Washington, a good depiction of the Congress. Number two, are you there? Hello?
Yeah, Gerald was having trouble hearing you, sir. Do you have a quick question?
Yes, I called the NRA yesterday, and they didn't seem interested in the Bob Costas thing whatsoever. I'm wondering if the NRA ain't in bed with Washington.
Yeah, well, that's what Larry Pratt reluctantly has been forced to say. He likes to be classy, but the NRA has sold us out in the past. They've got some better board members now. What do you think of Bob Costas now saying, hey, men 20 to 30 cannot be trusted with guns? And he's basically doubled down. We played the clip yesterday and just said, ban them all. Just men cannot be trusted.
Why would I care less what a sports announcer has to say?
No, I agree. But I mean, why are they? I mean, they're obviously using the NFL to go after our guns now.
Yeah, I mean, really. I mean, what is this guy? I mean, why should anybody listen to him? He calls games.
He also.
How about Kate Middleton? I wonder how her pregnancy's going.
No, I agree with you. But my point
is. Why listen to these people?
No, I agree with you. But the point is. You know, he carried the water for Sandusky as well. You know, my point is that this signals are coming after the guns. What's your take on the word that Obama may use executive orders outside of law?
Oh, definitely. As I said, as the world war heats up, we get shut down. Oh, they're going to use every two-bit excuse they can to take all our rights away, as they're already doing. The worst conditions become, the worst it's going to get. Just to put things into perspective how bad it's gotten. Go back 10 years ago, What was the price of gold in 2000? $250 an ounce?
Yeah.
Today it's $700. What was silver? $4 an ounce? Today it's $34. What was a barrel of oil? $20. What is it now? $90 to $120 a barrel? So look what's going on. The whole thing. Oh, by the way, over in, you've heard me talk about the whole world's collapsing economically. They just lowered interest rates again in Australia. The whole commodity boom is over there. They're doing everything they can. Governments all over the world pumping cheap money into the system. The thing is under collapse. I'm saying, look what's going on. The more it spins out of control, the more rights they're going to take away from us. And yes, they are going to do their very best to take our rights to bear arms away from
us.
No,
I hear you. I hear you. Incredible. I want to get to more calls. We're running out of time here, but I want listeners to understand, we're not hyping this. You know, the New York Times 4 years ago called you a pessimist porn dealer. Everything you predicted basically came true in one way or another. And then they're the ones caught lying about WMDs.
And selling the lie.
Gerald Celente is our guest. By the way, Joe Rogan tonight, the big interview I did last Saturday, all put together, edited. It's powerful. We're going to talk about, you name it, very serious issues tonight, 7 o'clock Central, prisonplanet.tv. We'll be right back with Gerald Celente. I want to hog Gerald Celente to myself, but I said I'd take a few calls. We're going to go to him. Gerald, just real fast, what is going to happen when the dollar stops, with the electronic food stamp stops buying for the Obama phone lady, you know, and stuff like that? What is going to happen with a giant group of people in this country who can't take care of themselves? I mean, it just looks like a powder keg.
Oh, you're going to see the gangbangers all over the place. And then more and more kids are going to join them. It is a powder keg. And again, we're squandering our resources in other countries while we should be saving this one. It's criminal. It's criminal. And again, listen to Eisenhower. Don't listen to me.
I agree with you. Well, it's just very interesting times here. They could accelerate the war any day now, folks. It's a powder keg. The Russians are there. Our troops are fighting Russians. U.S. troops next to Al-Qaeda troops are fighting Russians. I mean, this is just so evil. Insider in Washington, real quick question for Gerald Celente. Thanks for holding.
Yeah, no problem. Hello. I wanted to get his take on the new regulations that are coming up for the derivative traders in 2013 that is going to require them to put up trillions of dollars to satisfy the new margin requirements. And also, I was wondering if he was at all involved with the Spire Law Group lawsuit in East New York that is for $43 trillion against the United States government officials and the banksters. Thank you.
Okay, go ahead, sir.
Yeah, those are great questions. Yeah, no, the I don't think the derivatives laws are going to make much difference in any way. They'll come up with something else to get around and create something else new to rip off.
Because they run the whole show. That's cosmetic.
Yeah, so I don't see anything like that. To me, it has to be a full reinstallation of the Glass-Steagall Act. Nothing short of it.
You can't let investment banks create derivatives, period. They should all be arrested. I mean, all these guys dwarf Madoff.
Oh, well, he's just a fall guy. You know, you didn't see one big head roll on the whole Obama administration of anybody during that time. They get fined and they neither admit nor deny that they did any wrongdoings.
That's right. You know, we've turned things around when the big heads roll.
That's right. And you're not going to see it happen. And the other one, by the way, just a little side note, Eric Holder, the attorney general, he came from the White Shoe Boy firm that is now the law firm for MF Global.
Oh, yeah, that's how it works. George in Connecticut, last caller. Sorry to the others. A quick question for Gerald Celente. Go ahead.
Gerald, I'm just wondering. I have quick 5 points, and you can take any which one you want to do. I'm thinking of starting up a new bank in each state, just like George Green suggested, the Federal Reserve Bank, how he started. It's on the web. I mean,
talking about state banks. Okay, that's point one. We got about a minute.
How can we start any new wars? This is a commander-in-chief. Where's his credentials? He's Indonesian. He's a Kenyan. He's everything in creation, but we don't see a real birth certificate. Point three, IRS, why do the states just say, look, until you show us that you...
I'm going to have to cut it off there. Great questions. Gerald, what about the states' rights movement? You know, they're calling it secession. The Declaration of Independence says the states made the federal government. What about a counterbalance, because the feds have hijacked everything, foreign bank run? What about having the states say no to the federal government as a counterbalance?
Look at our top trend for 2012. One of them was secession obsession. It's real. It's going to happen. It's not only happening in the United States. It's happening in Spain. They just had a vote in Catalonia. They want to pull away.
I forgot. You said that a year before it started. You called it again.
It's right there in the Trends Journal. And it's in Wales, in Scotland. It's in Brussels. It's going around the world. They're having movements throughout the world, in the United States, to break away from, in Italy, to break away from central governments. It happened in the former Soviet Union, and now we have the new USSA. We just stole their arm. And so just as that broke up because of the corruption and the inability to run it, the same thing is
going
to happen.
Great job, Gerald. Great job.